Okay, welcome to the seventh session of Disadvantaged, our fifth edition live Dungeons & Dragons game with myself, Batty, as the DM, and a few of my friends. Golden Icon playing Gaikon, our mountain dwarf. Jazzy Wazzy 94 playing Clover, our gnome druid. Go Bro Buffett playing Broix, our bronze dragonborn bard. And of course, Gaddy playing Ruka de Lance, our thief rogue. Hey guys, how's everyone doing?
I'm great.
I'm a little nervous.
A little nervous? What are you up to? What's happening right now? What happened last time we played Dungeons and Dragons, guys? We had a week off. What happened?
Let's just say it's not the first time Ruka's been arrested.
Arrested? Ugh. I don't know. Mm-hmm. I don't know if arrested is the right word.
I would more say
taken prisoner.
Captured.
Yeah, we're not in a good way.
We surrendered.
Okay. Why? What happened? Where were you? Let's start with that. What were you doing? Where were you? What circumstances led to you being captured?
Just killing a bunch of cultists.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
True.
The big deal is.
I mean,
in the destroyed ruins of the city known as Caravol.
Close. Vol. Caravol. Yep. Caravol. V-O-L.
Excuse me. Close. My handwriting's ass.
There was a smudge. My bad.
Get it right.
We were sent there by Jackal.
Mm-hmm. He's so cool.
So cool.
Thank you. As he is cool. And we were sent there by Jackal to investigate the remnants or any evidence of the cultist activity. The Conclave has their own objective, but Jackal wants us to investigate outside of their intentions for his own. Those we're not 100% sure yet. Mm-hmm. We know that Caravol was raised to the ground in the last Grey War by dragons and dragonborn. That's why dragonborn are kind of hated.
Yeah, they started a bit of a war. It wasn't great. A lot of people died. A whole bunch of cities were razed. It wasn't frowned upon, one would say.
It was supposed to be vacant, but it's been known to house orcs, goblins, bandits, and the such over the past 100 years. We were told 100 gold bounty for every cultist or thing we had to kill in there, which so far we've killed 3. We started with the sleeping man and the destroyed house.
More than 3, buddy.
Pretty sure we killed 6.
Well, yeah, 6 total. But we only had evidence for 3 or 4. We found. Oh, when we woke him up. Tried to do it peacefully, but that didn't end well. Broba sung him a nightmarish lullaby as he stabbed a dagger into his.
Jeez.
Legit gave me nightmares. But he was telling us the Black Star will take you. That was what he said. The room had glyphs in a language that we don't understand written in white chalk. Cloverton turned into a fucking bear, which we learned is goddamn terrifying.
Yep, it's not great.
She shook a couple dudes around like a fucking pit bull. They have ornate onyx daggers. We took a couple of them. We wound up fleeing to like a bunkhouse barrack type area where we found about 11 bedrolls.
Yep.
We accounted for 4, I think. Four or five that we had killed, with noises coming from the entrance to what appeared to be a mine, or some kind of cavern. We set up position to hold there and wound up getting pincered. People coming up from the bottom, people coming in from the street. And we decided in the moment of panic that it was better to follow directions, lay down arms, than to try to fight this and get fucking wrecked.
Our bard suddenly went zen.
Yeah. the murder hobos certainly got less murdery.
Well, when you're surrounded, happens.
Even I know when to, you know, lay down my cards.
So yeah, that was a pretty decent recap. Yeah, you were sent to these ruins, the ruins of Katavol by Jackal for a little investigation. You were there. You killed some cultists. Some dudes were upset with you. You did some more investigating. Jazzy mauled a few people. It was fucking terrifying. It started to rain. You know, terrible spookiness. Eventually, yeah, a whole bunch of these guys showed up, and you kind of had an option of fight or flight, or fuck, get captured, and you went with fuck, let's get captured. Yeah, that pretty much sums it up.
The heavy armored knight name was Zephra.
Bam.
Okay, got that one. He hit Ruka in the back of the head. I feigned unconsciousness. I'm fucking hurt, but it feigned unconsciousness. Mm-hmm. And then the magic user came in and cast sleep on the party.
Yep.
Not affecting Ruka because he's a half elf.
Damn right.
I'm continuing.
You had your hood and everything up.
Yeah, I am continuing to feign this as long as it'll hold.
Okay. So, everyone. Mainly, actually, Ruka. As you feel your hands bound behind you, as everyone, you watch you kind of out of the corner of one of your eyes, you just barely have, you know, cracked open. You feel yourself picked up. You feel heavy, cold mail as you kind of notice the hand just kind of going limp in the arm. It's definitely this black knight, if you will. He's picked you up and he's bound your hands, and you can see he's got somebody else under his other arm. We're not quite sure who from your position, how you're hanging there. As you all are lifted, really. Not that any of you know, because you're all sleeping magically. Ruka, you feel your head, kind of the hair on your, or the back of your hood tugged as you kind of close your eyes a little bit more as they're now examining your face. You feel a strap or cloth tied through your mouth and bound at the back of your head.
I'm into it.
Shortly after, a hood is placed over your head.
Okay.
You feel yourself kind of bobbing as you're being carried. It's been only a short minute or so. This all took place very quickly. They bound you, hooded you, gagged you, and they're now carrying you down steps. Being very careful because of all the ball bearings. Yes.
I'm assuming it's like a burlap, so it's like...
Very hard to see through, but you can kind of make up some shapes.
Okay. Since I'm covered, I want to just kind of not move my head, but I want to see, do I see like a ring of keys on the black knight?
As you kind of, it's really hard as he's kind of got you under the stomach. So your head's almost looking down at the ground. You occasionally catch a foot walking by. From your angle, you don't spot any keys though. You're kind of jostled around, you don't hear any keys jingling, though you do obviously feel your hands shackled.
Got it.
Moments later, everyone else, you awake. Hands bound, mouths gagged, and hoods over your heads. You're all being carried. You hear step after step after step echoing around this tunnel you seem to be being brought down into. Anyone doing anything, or are you just kind of being carried?
I go with the flow. It's not like we can do much besides muffled yelling.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, I think I'm all set tight.
All right. Just making sure.
Just making a guess by the amount of footsteps. Can I get an auditory guess on how many people are carrying us?
Perception with disadvantage.
That's the name of the show.
Hey, it's my favorite thing to say.
5.
You know there's at least 4 or 5 people, but it sounds like more. An exact number, you're unsure. It could be the entire group that walked upon you. Could be more. It could be less.
Got
it. There's multiple people. You know that much. You saw at least four when you initially went into the tunnel before they threw the hood over your head, but that's really your number.
Okay.
It feels like 15 minutes, 20 minutes, 25 minutes. It's uncomfortable. There's the occasional break where they'll all stop. You're all placed on your stomachs. You'll hear quiet mumblings as they're talking to each other, trying to kind of ignore you as you're placed against, you know, a far wall. The air cooling around you. Everything kind of echoing and clattering. You seem to definitely be in some form of a tunnel still. Moments later, you're scooped back up, thrown back over a shoulder, or in some of your cases, thrown under an arm, and carried back down these tunnels. You feel the step after step kind of bouncing as they're going down deeper and deeper. 30 minutes, 35 minutes, continuing down and down. You hear a door open, a creaking as these old hinges. Door shuts behind you. Another 10 minutes or so. Another door. Another door. More steps as you go deeper and deeper. The air at this point is fairly cold down here. There's no breeze. There's no wind. It's fairly stale. Another door creaks. This time you hear kind of two doors, almost not necessarily in sync, but very quickly after the other. And they're very heavy iron sounding as they scrape along the ground a little bit. You all feel yourself thrown down onto the ground as the doors, and you hear the locks kind of click and fall into place.
While we're being carried, could I have tried to have kept any kind of sense of direction, like we made three left turns and a right, or two lefts and a right, or
make again, same thing, perception with disadvantage, or survival? Sorry, it'd be survival, not perception.
Survival.
Yeah.
Fucking three. It was an 18 and a three, so damn it.
As you were being carried down here and jostled and placed, it was very difficult to, you know, at first you remember, okay, we've been going for 10 minutes, left turn, door, going for another 10 minutes, stopped. And then eventually it all started to blend together. It was such a long walk, 45 minutes of this being picked up, carried, bounced around. You lost it after about halfway. You do remember, obviously, the last door you went through, the iron doors, as they were shut behind you and thrown in. And here you'll die, as you hear somebody walk away and then a door shut behind you.
Do I hear anybody else in there?
Silence.
I would like to try and get, like, use my mouth and, like, gnaw. Gnaw the fabric, try and rip it. Like,
her inner bear.
As you begin chewing on it, it's almost like there's leather in your mouth.
Leather's edible.
You begin chewing on the leather. What is everyone else doing?
Watching her chew on the leather.
Can I check to see if I have, like, any slack in my, my bondage?
So, you have irons on, your hands are behind your back and irons, locked.
Okay.
It's a hood, like a burlap sack over your head, so it's very hard to see through, just so you know, Gaikon, as well. You can make out shapes as you all kind of sit up and try to gather your bearings. Ruka. You see a shape hooded next to you. It's kind of hard to make out, larger. Gaikon, but again, you hear like gnawing or something, and looking as you kind of look around, trying to find that one little spot with no light down here. It's a shadowy figure next to you, small. Groix, you can't see a fucking thing. Literally nothing. Ruka, you hear that coming from next to you?
I said that boy. You did? No.
Gaikon, Clover, you hear these two off, kind of at a distance. With this almost sounds like there's some barriers in between you.
Alright, guess I'm gonna try to raise alarm just to see who responds voice wise around me.
Do I hear him?
You do.
Yeah.
You two are next to each other.
I'm gonna do a muffled.
Buddy, if I take a second and do the same thing, can I look for that little bit of light? Can I make out like the layout of the cell or the room that we're in? I'm assuming it's a cell.
Yeah. So, from your side where you are, there is, I mean, you can kind of see the very faint flicker of light, but it's not near you. Okay. Broax, you can't make with the hood over your head and where you're in the cell. It's damn near pitch black for you.
I'm fucked. Yeah.
With your night vision, Ruka, you kind of can, there is no light in this, like real light in here.
Okay.
You're seeing the gray of night vision, really.
Yeah. Okay. So just as a cursory thing, I'm just gonna is my back against the wall or can I shimmy until I find a wall?
Yeah, without you can kind of look around and see the three walls around you. You see at this point what you now know is the hooded figure of Broax in the cell with you. Stone walls around you, thick iron bars ahead of you.
Okay. I'm gonna say, bro, it's me. I'm gonna try something. Let me know if you know what, just sit still. And I'm just gonna try to find a wall. I'm just gonna shimmy until I get my back to a wall.
Easy enough. Yeah.
While he's doing that, I just kind of want to take my tail and just kind of like tap.
Oh yeah, Ruka. Talking. You guys remember you have gags in your mouth, so it's
Okay.
Yeah, very difficult to talk.
Okay.
I wondered if I was the only one gagged.
No. Everyone is.
Mine was by choice. I want to use my tail. I just want to smack the ground just a little bit, like almost like echolocation, give Ruka like a good sense where I'm at. And then also, can I use it just kind of like super like flip it around and see if there's anything like next to me or, you know, get a sense of what's around me?
Cold stone in a wall.
Okay. So you're slinging your tail around for echolocation?
Yeah.
Ruka, next to your slap, slap, slap,
this
slap,
can't
slap,
end
slap.
Badly for Ruka at all.
Fuck, it's like one of those books I read.
The iron shackles, would they be considered big on me?
No, they are really tight? Very tight on you.
Can I like somehow like close up my hand and like slide it through?
Yeah, so you kind of take a moment as you kind of try to hold your thumb in with one hand behind your back as you've been tugging on, and you can feel the metal biting into your hand and kind of cutting, and it's rusty and jagged, and your hand's definitely not coming out.
Okay.
I mean, you could probably try to like destroy, you know, break your thumb, and you know, if you want to get real weird.
How far have I eaten the leather in my mouth?
Not at all.
Batty, I'm still trying to shrimp along the floor until I can find a wall.
Yeah, I mean, it takes but a moment. The cells are not very big.
Okay, then
I'm gonna start moving myself towards Clover and see if I can't, you know, at least with my hands, even though they're bound behind my back, maybe get the hood pulled off of her head.
Yeah, without a doubt.
I'm just gonna follow the audio to where the audio for chewing on is, just to find it.
You're able to scooch over with ease.
When I find the wall, I wanna like scoot around on my butt and get my feet up against the wall, and I want to try to bring the shackles under my legs to where they're in front of me.
So yeah, you get, you know, your back up against the wall, and as you begin trying to pull them, you're fairly dexterous, and you're able to get the shackles from behind you, kind of feeling your shoulder straining and as you get your hands in front of you.
Okay, then I'm gonna try to get the bag off my head first thing.
Yeah, as soon as you know, you lift your hands, you start grabbing for the bag, you hear a door open. As it drags along the floor. Roix, for a moment you can kind of see, not really, not well, but like the bag in front of you lights up as seems like somebody carrying a torch walks in.
Okay.
Gaikon, Clover, you two, now fairly close to each other, though hooded, immediately see the light. You seem to be closer to this door. As you hear somebody walk in, scum, as he kind of grumbles at you, and you hear the footsteps kind of walk away from you. Broix, Ruka, you hear the footsteps get closer. Broix, you can actually see this bright torchlight directly in front of you now. Kind of sees you standing, Ruka. You hear him just kind of scoff at you as he turns and begins walking away towards the door. As the door is shut, the torchlight fades back into darkness.
Lovely. I want to put myself like in a corner on the same wall that that door's on.
Okay.
And get the bag off my head, pull the gag out, and reach into my gamma container and try to find the thief.
Sack, grab the.
Yeah, so as you kind of look, you realize most of your armor's been stripped. You've been wearing like bear clothing, maybe a couple pieces of patchwork are on there. Your knives, your dagger, your sword gone, bow gone. But managed to maintain a couple lockpicks.
Fuck yeah. Okay.
Not the entire set. But a few.
Yeah.
Your picks and then a couple actual tools to try to jimmy a lock if you need to.
Yeah, okay, that's all I need. Mm-hmm. I'm going to try to, first thing, looking at the door, is there a porthole or is it like an iron slatted door like they can see completely through?
The door that to your cell?
Correct.
Iron bars. You can see straight through, straight all through iron the hallway. Bars. All iron bars.
Okay, from where I am, I want to kind of like pie the door and I want to see, is there anybody actively looking into our cell right now?
Other than the figure who walked away and closed the door, there's no light in here. There's nobody here. The main big wooden doors into this center hallway that your cells are on seems to be closed, and there's no, like, bars or window looking from the outside doors into the actual cell room.
Okay. Then I'm going to go ahead and pick my shackles if I can.
All right, as you start to work on that, we're going to go back to Gaikon and Clover. What are you two getting at, too?
So, have I got her hood off yet?
Yeah, as you kind of scooch over, you're able to stand up and drag the hood off her face.
Is there any way I can assist with getting the gag out of her mouth as well?
Without a doubt. It takes a few moments as you kind of fumble, hands bound, as you're able to untie it behind your back, and it drops.
It's all slobbery.
It's disgusting.
Can I look behind me and see how sturdy the iron shackles are?
I mean, the one thing about these, they don't look old. They don't look like they were found here. They look fairly sturdy.
Okay.
I'm going to grumble at her, trying to indicate that I would like for her to take the hood and gag off of me as well.
Oh, I'm going to, okay, sit down. And I'm going to, actually lay down. It's much easier. You're much taller than me. So I'm going to have him lay down, and I'm going to take off everything from behind my back.
Yeah, you're able to pull the hood off, remove the leather strap that was tied around his head. So now that everybody except for Broux is unhooded.
I'm just sitting there, cock, cock, cock,
tail flailing around like a fish.
Am I able to see Ruka?
It's all bars.
Yeah, is you see a cell across. You kind of walk over to the bars in front of you directly. So you have cells that you're in, a hallway, a long strip in the middle, and then across this hallway, more cells. Directly to your left is a big wooden door, which you know that's where this figure just walked in, seemingly walking down the center aisle of this row of cells on either side. As you look across, you don't see Ruka. You have a stone wall. You have three stone walls, iron bars in front of you.
Okay. I'm just gonna shrug and take a small rest.
Mm-hmm.
And that's all I'm gonna do for now.
Okay.
I'm gonna call out for Rorux and Ruka, you know, just yell out for them, see if they're around.
Yeah, as you kind of quietly say this to them, you hear it, them muffled sounds from somebody down to your right.
And the tail flapping around?
You definitely hear flap, 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 flap.
So basically, I just want to call out to them and see if they can hear me and, you know, ask what the status is, if they're all right. Mm-hmm. They have any good ideas or plans.
I mean, I'm still gagged, so.
Ruga, do you by any chance hear me? Or?
Do I hear Gakon?
Oh, yeah, without a doubt. It doesn't sound like he's far.
Okay. I'm gonna keep quiet for now.
Is anybody out there?
I'm gonna do some panic muffled just trying to get someone's attention.
I'll grunt as if I still have something in my mouth.
What?
It's all right. It's all right. Just give me a moment.
I'm just gonna like scarf. Can I just like do like a quick like bolt of lightning, just like a little like snore, like just like a little tiny one.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Just a little crackle out of your nose as your mouth is like sealed, you know, kind of wrapped around the snout. It's not great.
Yeah.
So Ruka.
Nah.
You're trying to pick the lock on your hands? Is that what you're trying to do?
If there's a lock on the shackle, I'm gonna try to get the shackles off.
Yeah.
Then yeah, I'm gonna try to fumble with the if I get them, see if I can get them off.
Okay. Go ahead and make a thief's tool check, which should be Dex plus proficiency for you, I believe.
Correct.
Did you add? Do you have expertise in thieves' tools? I don't know. You'd have to select. Okay, yeah. I know you're proficient, but I don't know if you can select expertise as a rogue, or you can take like stealth or something else. It's not a guarantee.
I did. So it's double
proficiency. Yep.
Okay.
Maddie, by any chance, could I use my retractable claws as a makeshift lockpick for myself?
Yeah, you can try.
All right. I would like to attempt.
All right, go ahead and make a dexterity check with disadvantage.
17, Betty.
Okay.
And then I don't add the plus 8 if it's disadvantage, do I?
Just straight dex.
Just straight dex. It's going to be a 10.
So 10 total?
Yeah.
Okay. So as you you have your hands behind your back, Broix, as you fill in with your claw kind of in the pick, you hear it, and all of a sudden you hear it.
Hey.
It's still locked. Ruka, yours came undone.
Okay. Okay, then I will, as quietly as I can, take the shackles off. Do I still have pockets? I'm assuming my pants have pockets of some kind.
Yeah.
You have no pants.
That would be funny. But I'll kind of, as quietly as I can, like roll the shackle up and just put it in my pocket.
Okay, yeah, easy enough.
And then I will very carefully I'm gonna look again, just make sure that hallway's clear before I cross the door to go help bro.
As you take a moment, you look down. Figure it's only been a few minutes since he left. It's clear.
Okay, then I will stealthily move across the floor to get bro undone.
Alright, as you scuffle over Brooks, you feel somebody behind you.
Don't move. Don't move. I've got you.
No. Oh, no. Shut the fuck up.
He's going to start taking his bag off.
All right. Go ahead and make a... you can take the bag off. You're able to undo the binds around his mouth.
And shackles.
All right. Go ahead and make another roll. Same thing.
18.
Same thing. As you're able to take a moment. I mean, very definitely you... undo these don't seem to be the greatest picks or sorry the greatest locks or anything too fancy, just standard kind of cuffs.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna look at him, and I know it's very dark, but I'm gonna get close to his face and put a finger over my mouth, and we need to be very quiet.
I'm just kind of give him like a little okay, but then I'm gonna look at my shackles. I'm assuming it's just a solid, like, you know, iron band with just a simple lock on it, chain them in between both of them.
No chain, correct? two solid no bands attached.
Oh, so it's just
okay, like an you. Eight. Yeah,
gotcha. I want to look at Ruka, and since Noah and I have the retractable claws, I want to give him. Well, I might hold on my shackles, but I'm telling him like look at his and be like, oh, but God, shackles. Going for another cigarette, I see. fucking looking at the shackles, I'm like, make sure bright knuckle. If someone get close, you punch him in the fucking face with a number.
I was just gonna swing them, but all right, that's smart.
Actually, hold on.
No, bro, give me yours.
But what if it come back in and she might don't want my shackle?
Then we're fucking doing something, I guess. We can't stay here, we know that.
Okay.
And I'm gonna turn and start working on the door.
I guess I'm gonna stand there with my thumb up my ass.
All right. Gaikon, Clover, what are you guys up to?
I'm sleeping.
You lay down and sleep.
Yeah.
Is there a way I can test maybe thy bonds to determine if I could rage and break these shackles?
You can't break these cuffs.
But just to be clear, I'm trying to get a small nap in so I can have a short rest.
I don't think I like being confined this much.
It's going to be rough to get a short rest in this space, but I see you're trying. I like it. So, Guy, how did you kind of feeling intense on him? It's probably, barring a very, very high roll, not going to happen.
Fair enough.
Not impossible, without a doubt, but these aren't, like, it's not wood. It's just solid steel wrapped around you.
Acknowledged. I guess I'm just going to sit back and relax and let Clover enjoy her nap.
Maddie, quick question before I work on the door. Do I still have like any kind of like my little items pouch, like a butt pouch or anything like that, that greater healing potion would have been in?
Gone.
Fuck. Okay. All right, working on the door.
Okay. As you head over the door and you look at it, you see in front of you thick, very large steel bars, roughly 5 inches apart, kind of spaced. You see a big square metal lock directly in front of it. It seems fairly ornate, actually. Not simple in any way. As you kind of take a moment, focusing your eyes, looking around, you kind of see the beautiful stonework in here. It seems like this isn't just some throwaway jail cell. As you go to make the lock, go ahead and make the check.
Natural fucking 20 plus 8.
Take a moment, you kind of close your eyes as you feel rotating the pick in the dark. You feel the first tumbler pop. Second, and you realize you think you have the pattern with it, and you keep going, and then you, as you feel the lock creak open.
I'm going to turn back to Bro and say, are you ready to move?
I'm so happy right now, I can kiss you on the lips, Bob.
Shut the fuck up. I can see you. Nod your head.
Okay, bud.
All right, let's go.
Do I hear any of this at all?
You hear the loud click and then a little as the door starts to creak. You step out into this hallway.
Yeah. Before I step out, I want to look at like the stone on the floor. Can I see any kind of like a pressure plate or an alarm system or a trap or anything like that?
As you kind of take a moment to make an investigation check as you kind of scan the ground around you.
23.
As you kind of scan and look around, you don't see anything outward. You don't notice any traps, and you do remember a man just walked straight down and walked back.
Okay. So just kind of give it the cursory, like, you know, up against the wall, to the right, to the left, like looking down.
Yep. So you have a center hallway, either side a door. To your far left, the door the hooded figure entered from. To your right, another door, older, kind of dust covered, but that's to your right. You see five cells on either side of the hallway. If you look in Discord, you'll see a little.
Yeah, I see the map.
Oh, okay, thank God.
Okay.
You guys were in that the second to last cell. As you kind of scan and look around, you can see, you know, Gaikon and his burly beard kind of poofing through a few of the other bars.
Especially
as he's
once I heard
down.
That noise, I'm going to shimmy over and try to get my hands through the bars as much as possible.
Then I will start making my way through. I'm gonna grab Bro by like the hand or the wrist and help guide him, like so he doesn't bump into shit.
Okay. Bay, when we're out into like I guess the main stretch of the hallway, do I notice any light coming from either door, like underneath?
So the door closest to you guys on the right side, no light.
Okay.
The left side, a little very small crack along the bottom and around the edges a little bit. Yes.
Okay.
That'd be the door you heard the guy walk in from.
Another question: do the cell doors do they open both ways, or is it just a single swing out?
So they just open out into the hallway.
Gotcha. All right.
Ruka, as you kind of tell Bro, sorry, Bro, because you wouldn't actually be able to really see anything of here. You see that the faint bit of light. I mean, in here it is dark, and without dark vision, you barely can make out shapes. You may see the cracks of light through that one door, but that's about it.
Could I creep up to the door with the light and just like see if it's like a two way door, if it's like which way it swings out?
Yeah, you take a moment, you kind of like squinting, stepping quietly. Do you guys want to make stealth checks for me?
Yes, please. Dirty 20.
Okay.
19.
All right. As you both fairly deftly, Ruka walking up to the cell where you see, as you kind of look in, Gaikon and Clover lying on the ground in there. Gaikon's got his back turned and his cuffed hands kind of tucked like slightly through one of the bars, like seemingly ready to be released. Brooks, you walk up to this door. You feel the hinges on the inside, meaning the door swings into you.
Okay, I want to position myself in that blind spot if they open the door, and I want to ready my my claws.
Okay.
Just in case.
Yeah. You take a moment, and you just kind of flex your fingers, and those long claws grow just a little bit.
And I'll approach Gaikon's hands, and I see you've done this before, then. And I'll start picking them.
All right, go ahead and make the same check. Gaikon, make a perception check for me.
1 sec.
That's a rocking 12.
12. As you kind of...
need a calculator.
No, you're fine. Oh, Jesus. Gaikon, as you kind of look around, definitely dwarven in make. The bars, dwarven. This is definitely something that was crafted by your people. The walls themselves are very nicely laid. You see almost zero crease where the different stones were set, except directly on the back wall. Seems to be not necessarily a crack, but it looks odd. Like the setting, the stone. Yeah, as you're kind of focusing, looking at that wall, you hear it as your hands feel a little looser as the binds are undone.
But I'll tell him, step away from the door.
Okay, never mind. I'll save it.
And I'm gonna start working on the door.
All right, same thing.
Calculator, help. A 23.
Door clicks.
All right, and then I'll ask, do I see Clover, like, taking a nap?
Out on the ground.
Okay. Gaikon, is she okay?
She's fine. She's sleeping. I'm not about to be the one to wake her up.
How the fuck is she sleeping?
Betty, can I listen towards the door, see if I hear anything?
Yeah, go ahead and make a perception check.
damage. That's going to be a 17.
Just kind of listening, you hear the sounds of scuffling and ruffling just next to you, where Gaikon and Ruka seem to be undoing shackles, but nothing from outside the door.
Okay.
In this cell, or in our cell, because I forgot to look, was there like a cot or like a bucket to shit in or anything like
that? Stone empty. Okay. No mats on the ground, bastards. No pillows, nothing.
Okay. Then, I'll... if Gaikon's gonna wake up Clover, I'll let him do that, and then I'll wake up, and then I'll start her shackle.
Okay,
I'm not waking her up.
So, are you going in the cell?
Yes.
All right, you can wake her up.
Okay, then I'll step forward and kind of gently, like, rock her shoulder, be like, Clover,
I'm gonna wake up.
It's time to escape, love. Come on. Come on. You ready to get up? And then I'll start picking her shit.
Who's a good murder bear?
You are.
Yes, I am. How long did I roughly sleep?
I mean, it's been 5 minutes.
I'm gonna look over to him and just kind of, like, groan. You are so hasty when you want to leave. Okay. I'm gonna, like, present him my arms.
Excuse me, princess. And start Roix. On her fucking
tap. Roix. You hear shuffling or movement outside. It's getting louder.
I want to quietly notify the others.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just like, guys, and just kind of, like, point to my ear. Does it sound like more than one?
With that check, it's definitely more than one. You're not sure how many.
You got you. I want to motion towards Ruka, like, pointing back to her cell, and I want to just kind of, like, stealthily, like, book it back to the cell and kind of fake the cuffs back on.
Okay.
Ah, fuck. Okay. Then, if I'm able to get Clover's, then I'll follow Bruce.
So are you staying in the cell to try to unlock hers?
After that warning, probably not. Probably not. No.
The moment Brorux. Oh, hold on, sorry. It's so loud. Antune's gotta go spell.
Doors are hard.
Okay, I would like to cast Healing Ward, which
your
is just
hands
verbal.
Are still oh it's just verbal okay
first cool. Just verbal, yep, at second level.
Yep.
And 11 HP
to who?
To Ruku.
Okay.
Ooh.
Ruka.
How much?
11.
Just thank
and
you
then, and then I'm gonna be like, go
go go get.
All right,
go
then get. I'll book as fast as I can, and I'm going to try to quietly close that door behind me.
There's a slight click.
Okay, and then same thing with ours.
Okay.
I was going to say, I was going to just kind of fake my restraints back behind my back, but I'm definitely leaving the hood and the gag.
I'm just going to keep restrained.
Hoods and gags, are you guys putting them back on, or at least hoods? What are you doing?
I think it's reasonable. They would expect that we would have worked the hoods and the gags off eventually. I'm leaving mine off.
Okay. Yeah, me too.
I'm a bullshit. Just basically just stuff the leather gag in, leave it there loosely, and then put the bag over and just kind of like fake it. Just.
Yep. Ruka?
Same.
Okay. It was maybe 20 seconds later. You actually hear the steps outside the door. On the hard stone.
Can I change one thing on that? I'm sorry.
What?
Can I pinch like a little piece of the burlap and just make a little peephole for one eye just so I can see through?
Yeah, you kind of loosen some of the threads on it as you throw it back over your head so you have a small look and you throw your hands behind your back.
Perfect.
And then moments later, you hear that door drag across the ground as it opens again. Light. Gaikon, Clover, you kind of have to squint your eyes for a moment as it goes from that complete darkness to this room. You see one man walk in. You don't exactly recognize him, though his wardrobe you do. The black robes, the big purple star on it. You see him kind of shine the torch towards you, kind of hold it up. Got your hoods off. As he kind of looks at you both, kind of scans around trying to look towards your hands, it looks like. As he keeps walking. Weapons on him. Mm-hmm. As you kind of look towards him, there seems to be something on his belt.
When he walked past our cell, because he had to walk past our cell and see them.
Other door. Okay, they're at the front. They are the first cell.
We're on the left. You guys are on the right.
Yep. Guy, kind of, as you kind of watch him looking around in the doorway behind him, as the door is open there, you see two more figures just kind of leaning against each other, chatting quietly, just whispering to themselves.
Do I notice any weapons on those guys?
They're probably all armed.
I mean, is it well lit enough in there that I can clearly see them?
I mean, you can see. With the torchlight he's holding, you can see daggers and short swords.
We're so fucked.
Excellent.
He continues walking by you guys, walks over towards you, Ruka, and Gaika, and Broix. Dumb dragon. He walks away.
Can I just like kind of like crack off a little light and just like a fuck you?
He doesn't even take a second as he just continues to walk by.
I got the last word. I'm okay with that.
Is he walking back towards ours?
He is.
I'm gonna speak up. Hey, can I get any food?
No.
Why?
He just kind of looks at you.
I'm gonna like look up all innocent. Know me.
Ooh woo.
Apparently that's a charm.
You see him kind of look at you. Is you'll be fine. You don't need food right now. Maybe eventually, unless he wants you dead, then you'll starve.
Who wants me dead?
Okay. As he begins walking towards the door. Yeah, they're still in here. As he locks the door. Then you hear multiple footsteps begin walking away.
I'm gonna call out, I'm hungry!
You do that. As the echo of the footfalls fades away kind of behind the door.
I want to remove my hands and take the everything. I'm kill that son of a bitch.
No, I know. I thought about trying to grab his shit, but if there's more than one of them, I think it's a bad idea.
No, fuck that. Question now. Do you think we should just wait a little bit and kind of develop, see if they're on like a schedule now, boy, to come check the cells or whatnot, so we know how much time we have?
That's not a bad idea, but in the meantime, I do have something. I want to take my shackles, and is there like a corner of the stone where like the door meets like the wall, like a 90 degree corner of stone?
It's not of stone. It's like the bar wall are bolted directly into the wall, the stone.
Okay, perfect.
Like the bars run into them stones. You see like where holes were drilled where the bars are in.
Okay, and I'm assuming that the bars are round, correct? They're not like square too.
Round.
Okay. Well, just for shits and grins, I want to try to take the shackle that I have in my pockets and just try to file one down to some kind of a blade.
prison ship.
I'm improvising, motherfucker. What do you want from me?
You begin kind of start grinding on that.
And then I'll turn back to Bro. Listen, if we see a chance to either grab something or make a break for it, I think the schedule is a good idea. They seem to be sending multiples to check on us.
I'm just saying, if we can get them to where they feel comfortable and they start sending only one guy, like, oh, go ahead and send Jerry, go down there, he'll check, he'll be all right, he'll be right back. Then we'll get him.
That's why I'm doing this.
I just kind of, I'm gonna kind of look at him, just kind of like stem my claws and like give him like, yeah, I feel you now, boy.
Guy, just a little bit louder. Gaikon, are you good?
We're over here waiting on you.
All right.
I would like to use my hands again.
I know, Clover. I know.
I can't do shit.
For fuck's sake. I'm gonna try to push on the door. Did it lock when I closed it?
It did.
God damn it. Okay, you know what I'm gonna do.
make the roll. Basically what you're doing here is 18's the number you're looking for. Let me know if you do not get it.
Natural 20 again.
Okay.
And then on their door?
Yep.
22.
All right. Easy enough at this point. You seem to have it down how to, you know, how to unlock these doors. Though very well made, you're a thief.
Yeah, with a fucking +8 to my thieves' tools, thank Christ.
Batty, I want to position myself up by the door again and just listen.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll go to Clover and just, I guess she's laying down still.
Probably. I think you still got to get through our door as well, right?
He did. He just did.
Yeah, I unlocked it.
Oh, you missed that, I guess.
I'm fast, mate. And I'm going to work on that.
I guess what I missed is you unlocking your door.
Yeah, then I'm gonna start working on Clover Shackles.
Make a roll.
Fuck me, 23.
Easy enough.
You keep this up, boy. You're gonna get it.
I know shit. Okay. So Clover, listen. If they come back, you cannot show them your hands. You understand?
Can I just simply? Oh, I don't have my staff. Okay.
What do you need to do your things?
Some things I don't necessarily need the staff. Some things I do. It just depends. Like, I can do this, and I'm gonna cast a cantrip Primal Savagery and make my teeth really sharp and my hands really sharp.
You see her teeth slowly grow, her fingernails grow long, and her bone structure almost sharpen in just become a little bestial. It's fucking terrifying.
That is awesome. Holy shit.
That's why I needed my hands.
Well, then you should keep on that. You're onto something with that.
Want me to pretend that I'm savage?
No, we should keep that hidden, love, because if they come in to fuck with you...
Like a rabid dog.
Right. You get too close and you're like, oh, look, a cute dog. And then it bites you in the nads, right?
Yeah, and then they don't expect it. And then we kill them.
And you're the perfect height for that. Keep that plan. It's a good idea.
Okay.
I'll start going back to, well, so this time as I'm heading back to our cell, I just want to give a glance in the other cells. Are there other people here? Or is it just us?
It is just you. You do notice, though, the last cell, the one just past yours, has a wall that's slightly cracked in the back of it.
Hmm. All right.
Can I look at the lock on the door? Is it like a normal door with like a little thing that goes into the other end?
Which door? The cell
door.
The cell door?
Yeah, cell door.
It looks to be like there when the bars meet, there's some internal mechanism that has a multi-point like locking system. It's not just like a single latch.
Can I cut with my nails a piece of leather from my mouth gag and put it where the door latches and see if it can stop it from locking?
Go ahead, you can try.
I'm gonna try. What would I roll for that?
So first you're able to cut it, but we're gonna call it a sleight of hand check.
That's a 5.
So as you kind of cut this this little strip of leather and you put it in there and you just begin closing the, you know, pulling the door shut to try to get it to lock again. The leather is far too thick to allow that door to seal. And Gaikon, you see her doing this and it's almost amusing to you to think that the dwarves would make something so easily foiled, you know, like the craftsmanship in here is precise.
Yeah. And on the same token, I'm not exactly the brightest cookie in the...
It's nothing to do with it.
Either, so.
I think you have a specific thing about stonework and dwarven. You're a mountain dwarf still.
Regardless of how special I am, I know how futile that was.
Okay, Ruku, what's the plan here?
From down the hall. Hold on, hold on. And I want to try to pop that door on the one with the fucked up wall.
Betty, do I hear anything?
Wait, shouldn't we have Clover go bear form first?
I can't.
Why can't you?
You guys woke me up.
Well, maybe we should all get a long rest in and get recuperated before we go to start this.
So a short rest would be somewhere around an hour, a long rest, 8 hours. You do not hear anything yet. It's been maybe 10 minutes.
Okay, just making sure.
Fuck, I mean, a short rest isn't a bad idea.
I'm just going to shuffle back to the cell and slip on my attack and go to sleep, I guess.
In the short time, I'm sorry, was I able to pop the lock on the last door that fucked up?
Make a roll for it, brother.
16?
As you go and you take a moment, still locked.
Fuck. Okay. So did I hear Clover talk about the rest?
I'd say y'all can hear, unless you're specifically whispering to not let one of your friends hear, y'all can hear what you're saying. It's very quiet in here.
I mean, I don't want to spend any more time in here than we have to, but fuck, that bear is scary. Shit.
Do I see any rats or any small animals or anything?
No, actually.
I'll can I go?
Do you need more healing, maybe, or do you think we should rest?
I mean, I'm okay. I don't feel great, but I'm okay. Fuck. Okay. Can I try the door again?
Yeah, it gets a little harder if you can't fail it. Your pick getting stuck in there momentarily as you tear it out and you go back at it, make a roll.
Okay. If I get the feeling that I'm about to break one of my picks, I'll probably do what I can to preserve if I have a choice. Mm-hmm. It's better. It's a 20.
Door unlocks. You feel the pick get tight for a moment in there as it starts to bend a little, and you hold off, but the lock happens to be unlocked. You do feel a little tension in that pick at this point, as in it's getting worn.
Well used, yeah.
Yeah. This is a lot of opening and closing all the shackles. It's a single file. Normally you have an entire set to work for. You only have a couple of these right now, so.
Yeah, whatever I could hide in my inner thigh. So gooch. I'll, yeah. Fine. So I'll, if I can just pop that door like ever so slightly,
mm-hmm.
where it's just not latched, I'm just going to leave it like that.
Okay. Yeah, it's, you leave it, I mean, a hair split open, just.
Okay, then I'll go back to our cell and tell Bro and just, listen, the wall next door is proper fucked. I think if you
it's not blown out, just it's not like a blown open hole, but it's cracked and you see a chunk of stone falling in.
Okay, so but it's like compromised.
Yes.
Okay, so I think that if you and Gaikon work together and smash that thing, I think that might be our emergency exit.
I'm just
I
gonna
can use Earth Tremor.
I'm gonna give him a muffled "Oh, we'll go down, boy," and I'm gonna try to go back to sleep.
Okay.
What was that, Clover?
I can use Earth Tremor. If there's a broken piece of the wall, I'm not sure if it will work all the way, or if anything else will fall on us, but it might work.
I'm going to look over at Ruka, give him one of those, "Hey, what do you think of this plan?" kind of looks.
I mean, that's not a bad idea, mate. In the time we have until the patrol starts coming back, Betty, I want to go back to work on sharpening my shackle.
Okay, you take a few more grinding on it. Roix, you're in your cell, right? You're not at the door?
Yeah, I'm in my cell now.
Okay, so everyone...
Go ahead and start that short rest.
Everyone else, is everyone kind of in the same positions? You're pretending to be locked up, you're resting, hoods on or off?
I'm going to pretend I'm locked up while I'm doing my short rest.
Okay. Groix, I know you are a guy. Ruka, you too.
I'm definitely.
Yeah, I know you are. I meant.
Yeah, I'm. I would like to stay close enough. Like, I really want to try to get some headway on this blade that I'm trying to make. But otherwise, if I can be close enough that I can like sit down real quick, throw the hood, you know, throw my shit back on.
Mm-hmm. All right. It feels like another 20 or so minutes, so roughly a half an hour total. You hear that same, that last minute, that last second where somebody's outside the door, because nobody's at the door listening right now, but you hear a couple of footfalls right before you hear the door as it kind of squeaks a little and grinds open.
Get back to my spot.
The same light shines in, kind of blinding you for a second, Gaikon, Clover. They see you on the ground resting, and he kind of shines his light over you, looks, walks down to the next cell, holds up the torch, sneers a little again. He begins to walk back towards the door. They're resting. They look real comfortable. And then you hear the door shut. It doesn't lock.
Hmm.
Hey, Ruka, did you notice that door didn't lock?
I sure did.
You still see the light kind of cracks throughout the door. You hear some more footfalls. The door opens again. This time there's more people. They all walk in. You see them kind of look in the room and they begin dumping water inside onto the room, soaking you.
Bastards.
Fantastic. Is this washing some of the blood off of me?
Yeah, a little bit.
Clover's just gonna like lift her head with her arms behind her back.
Good, you're awake now. Wonderful. Let's not be getting any sleep tonight, at least. Maybe soon. You see one of them kind of speaking up. He has a thin little mustache and a goatee, same robes and hood, as he has a little thing kind of pop up on his shoulder. You see little eyes.
Is it an animal?
It seems to be some kind of a creature, yeah.
Cute. Can I identify it and see what kind of animal it is?
Well, it happens to hop onto the bars, kind of holding on to him. It's got a long, spindly tail, little tiny wings. Its skin is slightly yellow, and as it kind of gets closer in the darkness, you see its eyes wide and bright, bright yellow, almost glowing in the darkness, thin, reptilian-like pupils. You hear it snarling, kind of, no, go. As it jumps in on the room, it kind of skitters around the floor in front of you. As it gets closer and closer.
It's small enough to go through the bars, huh?
It is quite small. As it gets closer to you first, Clover, you notice it's not a creature you've ever seen. And it doesn't look natural in any of its forms. As its snarling mouth gets close, you see it kind of clamber closer to your leg. Closer now. Keep going. As it gets right up next to you and you see its little hands kind of reach out and climbs onto one of your legs.
Can I kick it?
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to kick the fuck out of it.
Make an attack roll.
It's not an animal. It's okay. Don't call people.
An unarmed?
Yep. Unarmed attack.
That's a 7 to hit.
It kind of, you shake your leg and it kind of digs its claws in. It hurts a little as it kind of holds on. Good. And you hear him, as he begins moving his hands around and he holds one out on you. And you see almost a snap where the little creature on your leg begins to glow slightly. As it sends searing pain.
Why though?
Welcome to prison, bitch.
You take 8 points of necrotic damage.
What? Can I try and fucking headbutt the fucking creature?
You just missed, and it zapped you in the meat as soon as it jumps off, kind of flapping its wings, hovering for a moment as it floats down on the ground, kind of cocks its head at you, Gaikon. Now, next. As you watch it kind of skitter, flap up, and it kind of jumps at you, Gaikon.
I'm just going to try to maintain my composure as best as possible and not flinch or give it any reason to attack me.
It does the same thing, right? It kind of climbs up to your leg, and you see this cloaked figure. Naivoy Nuna, as he begins casting again. You take 11 points of necrotic damage.
But did I only hear one come in?
No, there was many more. You heard many more footsteps walk in. Gaikon, Clover, immediately outside the door, you see one who's flanked by two on either side, and you at least see one in the doorway. They don't seem to be taking any chances with you.
Smart.
As this pain zaps through you, you feel your legs slightly burn, Gaikon, as its little hands singe into you, as it flaps off.
Just going to try to maintain my composure, keep arms behind my back so they don't know that I'm loose.
As you kind of flex and deal with it, you're just kind of grasping both hands tightly together behind you. You grunt. The pain kind of subsides. Come now. Elliot, come. As this little fucking critter flies up, lands on his shoulder. Small tail. Velliot.
More like bitch.
Got him.
I'm riding Demon Squirrel.
Demon Squirrel? Fair. As he begins walking down the hall, two of the goons stay kind of watching you too. As he gets down to see Broix and Ruka. What are you both doing? You're both...
I would have gotten back to my spot with the bag still on, using the little peephole and feigning hands behind the back.
Okay, Betty, quick question. The cell we're in,
yep.
Is it like, so I'm assuming is it a square or rectangle cell?
More rectangle.
Rectangle, is the door like closest to the wall, like the dividing wall, or is it like in the center of the cell?
The whole fourth wall is that iron bar. It's three stone walls and the two side ones being longer, so it's a little elongated. Yeah. Iron bars across the front.
Gotcha. I want to, where I'm asleep at, I'm kind of like position myself like in like the back corner beside both walls, but like I'm tucked into the corner, my tail's like closest to the, I guess to them.
Sure.
But I'm still bound and sleeping.
Wakey, wakey. No time to sleep yet. You've trespassed and now you'll pay. As you see this little thing like jump to the bars, Ruka, you see it. Broix, you don't. In this dark, you see the light kind of shapes of people in front of you as this little creature jumps through the bars again, flapping closer. Ruka, you kind of watch it land right at Broix's feet. Broix, you feel something on your tail.
All right, I want to take my tail and I just want to whip it as fast and as hard as I can into the wall.
Make an attack roll.
Fuck yeah.
It's an unarmed attack.
Bro uses tail whip.
unarmed. It's under addition, right?
It should be under a tail. Let me check. I got you right here.
It's under attack.
Unarmed strike, plus five.
Plus five. 23?
As it's slammed up against the wall. Oh, I wish you wouldn't have done that. Open the door. As this little thing starts squealing and crawling away, Ruka, you watch as this little demon-like creature starts crawling away and it reaches this hooded figure. Come now, Velliot, come. As he scoops it up and kind of places it on his shoulder a little bit. It's just like, kind of bloodied up. As one of the doors is open, it's swung open. Now, I'd suggest you not swing that tail at me or you'll lose it.
I want to kind of like muffle, like as if I'm just waking up, like, what?
I mean, you can't even see your face. I'm not even making, it's not even a roll.
Just making the noise where it's like quite obvious. I just woke up and like that was me asleep and like thinking it's like a fly or something.
So he just kind of walks up and grabs your tail. And this is the pain part. You take 9 necrotic damage as you feel pain shoot up out from your tail all the way through your spine and back into your neck.
Yeah, just give out.
As he kind of walks over towards you, Ruka. At least you're quiet. He just kind of grabs your wrist. Or not your wrist, sorry. Your upper arm. Your hands are behind your back, right?
Correct, yeah.
Yeah, so he just grabs your shoulder and like upper bicep. And he does the same thing. Nine, 11 necrotic damage.
There goes that heel.
That wasn't there.
There'll be no sleep tonight.
As he begins.
It'll be a shame if you die. As he walks out, kind of holding his hands out, tingling with this arcane power as the door shuts, closes. Out! Leave them! As they all walk towards the door, it closes. You hear the latch lock, and the many footsteps kind of fade away in the distance.
Taking the bag off my head and just rub the arm like a boo-boo. Be like, motherfucker.
Do the same, kind of like take my tail and just kind of like rub my tail to like...
He's hugging your tail.
Batty, can I like feel around on the wall where I swatted whatever the fuck that was? Is there anything left over, like any teeth or maybe it had like a little bag on it?
There's a little smear of blood that you feel. It's a little wet. It didn't die, but it hurt.
I want to take a second while we have time, and have I made any headway on this shackle to like give it any kind of an edge?
You can feel it starting to grind, but it is going to take some time.
All right, fuck it. I'll keep it as like a, you know, improvised cases or something.
Okay.
Betty, am I able to cast Cure Wounds?
Your hands are free, I mean, you don't. It should say on the spell if it requires your hands to be free or what. It will say like.
Well, I mean, VSM. My hands are.
Yes, and you 100% can.
Okay. You know, feeling bad for, you know, essentially getting Ruka zapped by like the necromancer. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I just go up to him, and I place my hand on his shoulder, and she's like, "Sorry, I fucked up. Have some heal."
Thank you, bro.
The acoustics in here, beautiful.
Dude, fucking, they got that hall reverb, dude. Mm-hmm, like,
It's just, ooh, it's good.
Too much.
I'm gonna step a little closer to the door or the iron bars and kind of like talk towards Ruka. Okay, we need to get out of here because that hurt.
Wait, so I got it's 1d8 plus 4, right?
Yes.
That is going to be 9.
9? Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
No, thank you.
Then I'll get up and try our door. Is it fucking locked?
It is locked.
Damnation. Okay, here we go. That is it's above 18.
Okay. As you take a moment,
calculator.
Again, you feel the pick starting to wear a little bit, but you pop it.
And I'll quietly do that. Mm-hmm. Go get.
I'm just gonna go ahead and position on that door and listen again.
Okay, as you post up listening, make a perception check.
13.
You don't hear anything right outright, but you're readying, you know, you're listening just in case.
Okay. And I'll prepare my clothes.
And just so you know, Clover or anybody else who is, they seem to be trying to make sure you're unable to gain any kind of rest.
Yeah.
I noticed that.
Okay. Just making sure.
Batty, dirty 20 on their door.
Your pick snaps.
Okay.
The door does open. You're able to get the lock, but as you begin to pull it out, the end of it snaps off. You do have a spare, but They are being used quite on heavy, heavy doors.
Okay.
I'm gonna exit and go to the cell that he was talking about where the stones are, but okay. the wall is being kind of broken.
Yeah, as you kind of walk back towards that wall, the door is still open. They didn't seem to have noticed that slight crack.
I'm gonna push it open slowly and...
You pull it open. They open out into the hall, but yeah.
Okay. I want to examine the wall and then go over and try and, like, push any loose stones.
So as you make a...
I'm going to walk over with her as well and observe the wall and see if I can find any kind of faults or issues with it or structural that can be done.
So this would be a situation for help. Either you could help her or she could help you. You as a mountain dwarf get a little bit extra for examining stonework of the dwarven kind.
What do you think, Clover? Should I have a look at this?
I'm going to look at it. Yeah, it's stone. You should probably look.
Oh, you bud.
Gaikon, go ahead and make a history check with advantage, and then you get to add double your proficiency bonus to this.
Hey, Batty.
Okay.
Can I take my broken... So, the pick, would it be, like, the size of a pencil or smaller? Like that?
It'd be smaller.
So, like, that?
Oh, yeah, about that in length, but much thinner. Sorry.
Okay. Where it broke... Can I take my shackle and start trying to fucking make an ice pick out of
it? Sure.
Oh, can I take my shackle after I help Gaikon and shove it in the door where they keep coming out of and try and, like, jam it?
Okay, you try to wedge it under the door to almost make, like, a stop?
Yeah.
Yeah, sure. All right, so Gaikon, what did you roll?
Let's see, that would be a 19 minus my one history, and you said add the proficiency as well?
Add the proficiency so times two.
22.
There you go. So as you take a moment and you start following the very, like, beautiful stonework throughout, even in a cell, it's like they took time here. As you follow the seams in where you watch the side walls are almost sealed perfectly. There's almost no seam. As you get to that back wall, you can see it was kind of patched up at one point. The lines don't quite mesh up. The stonework itself is almost a different size and material. And one section, somewhat just like at the top of your reach, is kind of cracked. And you see a small fist-sized hole almost where old stone has collapsed. It looks to be this hole was patched hastily or by somebody who is not a master craftsman of... the dwarven kind.
Hey, well, I'd like to say maybe reach around, feel if I can feel any kind of buttons, levers, anything abnormal about it, pull out anything that's loose.
Yeah, as you kind of reach up at the very, again, you're on your tippy toes at this point, as you dig your hand kind of in there, you feel around, there's no levers or latch, it just feels like with age, this shoddy craftsmanship has started to deteriorate.
And how far is this spreading? Just this one little area, or
It's not the entire wall, but a good, like, 4 feet. The walls, the cells themselves are about 8 feet wide and about 10 feet deep.
How's the ceiling and the floors look structurally?
The same as the walls, like pristine dwarven craftsmanship. Even over the hundreds of years these have been down here, there's very little wear.
But it is placed walls and not carved out stone.
Placed walls.
Okay. Clover, about that spell. Think it'll do us any good here? This wall's pretty weak.
Yeah, I mean, I can try it. It may not do anything, though. I can't guarantee anything. Do you guys want to just, you know, ram into it?
Yeah. How stealthy is the spell?
It's like an earthquake. Clover's just gonna say fuck it and just kind of like charge and like use her shoulder and run into the wall.
I'm gonna grab Clover, move her away from the wall.
As she starts, little tiny thing. Just, I mean, you catch her before she headbutts a wall and just like.
Batty, I want to motion towards Clover and just tell her to trade spots with me. And like, you know, as we're passing, I just wanted to just, you know, listen how you hear our comments, just warn us and we'll get in our cell, you know. You know what to do, little lady. I got you. And then
how much quieter is us trying to crash through this wall gonna be though? I mean, we're talking about a wall crashing down with rubble and all.
Well, it's either this and we make a run for it, or we go.
There is a third door in here. Door. There's two doors.
You said it's the back right one, like right there by the door. Before I enter the cell, I just want to kind of like give like, you know, the door handle a little like just to see what's.
So like, as you kind of tug on it, seems it, open. It seems stuck and locked, but it's a much older looking door. I shouldn't say an older looking door. It looks less used. Like the door that they've been coming in and out of, there's no dust on it. It's not settled. This back door doesn't look like it's been opened in who knows how fucking long.
Got you. Peering into the cell that Gaikon's in, is there like any light coming through the crack?
No light, just dark.
No light.
I'm gonna have my ear against the door and try and listen and hear anything.
I want to motion towards Ruka and just either like point at the crack or point at the door and be like, you know, I don't want this to be a broom closet, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's a good point. I mean, if you'd like, I could try and open it.
Actually, no, I'm gonna look towards Gaikon and I'm just gonna like nod towards the thing and just like, you wanna do it now, buddy?
The crack in the wall?
Yeah.
All right, so I'm gonna grab him and kind of guide him over to the crack and show him where it is since he's completely blind. Have him lean his shoulder into it and be like, all right, this is where we're trying to hit.
Okay.
And then motion him back to where we're gonna start.
Nod, and I'm just gonna kind of like crack my shoulders and everything, and I guess like count of three, I guess we're gonna give a good little pushy push.
All right. We're gonna do individual strength checks for this one. I like this. So as you both begin to charge at this busted wall, can you each give me an athletics check?
Here. 17.
Okay.
16.
You both just sprint full and you dive shoulder and you feel sugar cube. You hear Broix with his silent, here's quiet sugar cube charge as your shoulders both connect, cracks as a couple rocks fall. Not the entire wall, but.
Any light?
No light.
No light.
It's leading into darkness. Clover.
Huh?
This wasn't quiet. Ruka, you would obviously know this was not a quiet maneuver.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead and make a perception check.
Eighteen.
Look at that.
Yeah.
You hear against the wall. You put your ear against the wall, listening. Silence.
I'm gonna put my thumb up.
Motion towards Gaikon. Same thing. Just like, if it don't come down this time, you know, get back to ourselves and we'll wait for the next round.
I don't. You think there's no way they didn't hear that? I mean, just because they're not coming now.
Gaikon, just do it. We gotta get out of here.
I'm gonna turn to Gaikon.
Let's go.
I'm gonna turn to Gaikon and say, "Boy, this time, imagine the wall said something mean about your bear friend, right?"
All right, and I just want to imagine someone finding Sugar Cube and killing him, and just like channel.
Oh yeah. If a bard could rage, you would have just done it.
So, I mean, me raging doesn't give me any advantage, right?
You have an advantage on, I believe, strength checks while you're raging, yeah. Athletics would be a strength check.
All right, count of three again.
Let's do it.
Full sin.
All right, Broix, same thing. Make an athletics. Yeah, and Gaikon, you have advantage on your strength check as you charge headlong into this wall.
Sixteen.
22.
Broix, as you go charging. You notice Gaikon isn't right behind you as you slam your shoulder into this wall. A couple more rocks fall and tumble over your head as you kind of see a moment of this dwarven head look up. You see his veins pulsing, his eyes almost whited out.
Knowing that, I'm a back away.
I mean, as you immediately start to say, it's almost like in this darkness, it is a terrifying, shaking presence as he sprints head first into this wall, just crashes through it. There's a dwarf size hole.
Okay.
I'm gonna listen again on the door.
From my height, that's about the weak spot that was on the wall then.
It's about the weak spot of the hall. You went right through it.
Same thing on my door, Betty.
What door are you on, Ruka?
I'm on the opposite one from
Oh, sorry, you're on the old dusty door.
The old room closet, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're listening for any movement.
Yep. You hear very muffled footsteps. Not you, Ruka. Clover.
I'm gonna go.
At a distance.
Okay.
They're coming.
We gotta go soon. They're coming.
I'm gonna peek into the hole, alert Gaikon, and as I'm doing it,
when you're coming out, just do your best, kind of make it look like it didn't happen, and then you'll barely close it.
I mean, I'm assuming with him being a dwarf, if he's just trying to patch it up like real shittily, it's still gonna look good. Probably better than the guy who did it beforehand.
I'm gonna throw up a stone wall I just broke down.
Yeah, just you stack rent that way. It just doesn't look like a giant fucking hole in the middle of the cell if they happen to peek in. At first glance, and be like, okay, wall still.
Oh, or we can bamboozle them. We can go through the door, the other door, and then we can go through the wall or something. Either one, and we have both open.
What does it look like in this room I just broke into?
It seems to be some sort of tunnel. It's not a mage structure. It seems to be in the ground. It's old and somewhat damp in here.
Let's go.
Okay. That case, change of plans. I want to motion towards the others. Tell them to come up here and
we all fit in there?
Yeah, 2x2 probably.
Oh, thank Christ. Okay.
Brobar would have to be on his hands and knees, but that's okay.
It's not super tall. Like Broix might be ducking a little bit, but it's not bad.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, I'm gonna go in there and
we funnel in. I wanna ask Gaikon just to like push as many rocks as he can and stack them and just kind of fill the hole, just to buy us enough time so it's not obvious. Like, hey, fucking hole, guys.
Would I be able to minor illusion the hole back to normal?
What's the size of the space on my... I mean, you could...
5 feet?
5 feet? About a 4 foot hole, yeah. And it's
4 foot hole.
Okay, I'm gonna tell everyone to get in, and I'm gonna minor illusion the wall back. Can I do it to where it was the, like, beautiful structure again?
Are you guys... So, yes, as you all get in there, are all the other cell doors shut?
I'll close them as I make my way back.
All right, you close the first one, you skip a few, you close yours... You step into this last cell where the wall was just broken in. As you, as Gaikon, you see him kind of brushing a lot of the debris out of the cell itself. And you pull those doors shut. You step through. Clover, you take a moment, kind of scan the room as you hear the far door begin to grind open. That light floods in as you throw your hands up.
So the shackle was ineffective?
Oh, immediately just pushed open. It's a metal shackle on a stone floor. It just scraped. It was loud.
It was a good idea. Whatever. It was a good idea.
It wasn't no battle axe leaning against the door, you know? As the doors open and you take a moment and you throw your hands up, casting minor illusion. As the light gets closer, you see them, wait, the cell is empty! And we're going to take a break.
Oh, shit.
Boggers.
Good timing. I gotta pee. Anyway.
Boggers, dude.
You gotta piss like a what, Broba?
Piss like a racehorse.
Like sugar cube?
Giveaways. Please send Jackal. We need him.
Jackal. All right, guys. Thank you everybody for hanging out and watching. We are going to be doing a giveaway very soon here. Let me set this up. What is our keyword this time? I think stone. All right. So, if you would like a chance to win a set of dice. And get a dice package. Go ahead and type exclamation stone in chat. You'll end up getting some stickers and such. I usually send those out with them. Exclamation stone. You don't need to keep spamming it. One fucking time does it. All you got to worry about. Go ahead and toss that in there, guys. We'll do the drawing right before we start the whatever the fuck I'm trying to say. The rest of the session. I'm gonna run to the bathroom. Enjoy the fucking spooky tunes. I will be right back. Stone!
Chat. Alright, I'm quiet. Maddie's back.
Hello? Swander, A2 Conley, Philae, Z, Mario, Martrix? Martrix?
What the fuck is wrong with my mic?
Oh my god, it's so bad.
What is it?
There's some kind of auto going on with it. Like, if you're quiet for a long period of time and then you talk, it's like, then it comes back to normal. After like a second or two, but it's like auto. There's like some kind of auto gain on it or something like that. It sounds like.
Shouldn't be.
Like it's fine, and then it's terrible for a minute. Then it goes right back to being normal right after you speak.
Is there any setting on this mixer you got me?
It shouldn't be on that. It would be Discord. I would assume. So what I think it is. I'm assuming you Discord's auto. Or do you have it set to a specific input set volume?
It's set to a specific.
Never mind. I have no idea then. If it was auto, I would assume it sounds like when you're silent, it's trying to pick up quiet sounds in the background. You know? So when you talk, it's like, oh, fuck, loud.
Maybe put the sensitivity down a little bit lower, I guess.
Yeah.
Maybe. I don't know. Fuck. Good luck.
I mean, it's fine now. Like, it sounds completely normal. It's like I said, it peaks for a moment.
Mm-hmm.
Then it's fucked.
Weird.
Yeah.
Maybe take the gag out.
He looks better with it in.
No, I'm leaving that in. Thank you.
Again, thank you guys all for the follows. I know I'm not reading chat or acknowledging anything while the game's going on. I'm telling a story, so I ignore you fucks. I'm busy with these guys. But at the end of the session, we will give away more dice. But for now, one last chance, exclamation stone, STONE in chat right now. If you want a chance to win some dice, which I'll send out Monday or Tuesday or whenever I get a chance soon. All the other ones have made it. That's all that matters. Let's see. Yeah. Sentek, thank you for the follow as well, brother. How's everybody in the group? You guys, are you guys good to go?
See, yeah. Ruka may not have armor, but I do. You can't hurt me emotionally, Batty. We're on the internet.
I can.
You can hurt me in every single way.
What?
Or not a weird way.
All right, here. Let's go ahead and roll this. Oh. No, we're good. Okay. Roll. Harkilla. Are you in chat? Hello? Friend? If you're here, please hop in Discord. Shoot me a message. I'll give it a minute. If you're not here, I'm going to send it again. Oh no.
What?
Arkilla's not answering.
They're lost. Idiot.
Rude.
It's because I said you were sweet earlier, wasn't it? You're making up for it.
Oh no, I always say idiot.
Arkilla, last chance. I'm gonna send it again. Guys, if you type in chat to try to win dice, be in the fucking chat, please. All right. Sorry, Arkilla. Oh, gross. Oh, Tafer won.
Nice.
I mean, yay, Tafer.
Gross.
Tafer, you want dice? You want me to roll it again? Yes or no? You want him?
I mean, he's here.
I mean, I'm asking if he wants him. Hell yeah, perfect.
He wants him. Of course
there you
he
go. All right, Tafer. Discord me, brother, the place where I can send you some dice and some stickers and shit. Roll again. Put those in there. I'm gonna get you some real fruity looking dice. It'll be wonderful, brother.
Oh, Batty, you might like to know this, but I've got 4 Batty stickers hidden in the gun shop. We'll see if anybody ever finds them.
Perfect. Really?
Right. Yeah, it's pretty
that
awesome.
That sounds amazing. It gives me a goal or something to do while I'm waiting next time.
It's a fucking sky. Oh, yeah, they're on the sales floor. If you know where to look, you'll find.
All right.
Why do you do this big? Ugh. Wasted opportunity. Missed opportunity.
So, as you all... Let's get back into the game again. I am Batty, your DM. I'm gonna ignore chat again as we're getting back to the game. I have Golden Icon playing Gaikon, our mountain dwarf barbarian. We have Jazzy Wazzy 94 playing Clover, our forest gnome druid. Go Broba Fett playing Broix, the bronze dragonborn bard, and of course Gaddy playing Ruka de Lance, our half elf thief rogue, who now has a mustache. It's just how it is.
The thin, they weird shaved his mustache when they captured him.
Yet here it stays.
As you hear this figure who was in there, who was hitting you with a little arcane punch earlier, you hear him yell out, "They're gone! Check the cells!" As you see multiple figures come running into the room, torchlight going, as you see one figure, Clover, as you're standing there just behind, holding this small patchwork up, kind of mimicking the space around it. We're going to say, I'm going to say it's your spellcasting spellcasting DC.
Okay.
And they're going to try to make an intelligence check.
That'll be a 14? Yeah.
Is it?
I think.
No. 16.
Six? Oh, good.
I believe you're, right? Spellcasting DC, it's 10 plus your wisdom plus your proficiency, which is 2. Yeah, 16.
Okay.
So, it's a straight roll. As you see the light and you see multiple figures in this room, kind of holding up torches room, you see one come directly to the cell in front of you guys, holds a torch, shines it in, looks, and immediately turns across the hall, looking into another cell. They're not here! As you see him kind of turn to this dusty door, and they begin pulling, and the door's locked! It's always locked! As they start banging on the door, trying to tear it down. And they begin running in and out of the room as you hear a lot of commotion. How long can you hold that?
It's a cantrip. 1 minute. And then I have to cast it again.
Okay. What are you guys doing?
I'm going to back away as far as I can, 30 feet.
Okay.
As they move, I'm going to motion them to move back as well. because I'm still casting it, and okay. I'm gonna get to the max range.
Yep.
And hold it until I have to cast it again.
As you begin backing down this tunnel, it's almost, it starts to round a corner, probably around 20 or so feet. So you'd have to kind of stay on that corner to be able to see where you're casting the spell.
Okay.
And it takes one action as the casting time, so it's not instantaneous as well. So there's going to be a moment. There's nothing there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. As you begin backing down this tunnel, everyone else is down there. Are you guys staying there with her? Are you continuing moving? Are you casting again, Clover?
I want to motion towards Ruka and Gaikon to just basically continue down. And I'm going to stay with Clover just in case.
You hear from the top of the tunnel echoing, "Get this door open!" as they start smashing, and you hear banging on this door up at the top.
You're talking about the
Other wooden.
Okay, gotcha.
What are we doing, Clover? Are you? You're about 45 seconds.
I'm gonna cast it again.
Okay.
I'm gonna slow my pace when I'm about 10 feet ahead of Bro, or in front of Gaikon.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to start kind of skulking as slowly as I can.
So how far does the hallway look past the turn? So we're ahead of them. That's
down. It begins the turn again around another corner, probably another 30 feet down.
It's going down, though?
Oh, it is going down deep. You have that cold air breeze kind of feeling coming up from it.
As I'm casting it, if I have any slight of, like, if I see anyone notice that it was an illusion, I want to immediately cast another spell. Only if they see me.
So you're down in this tunnel.
Mm-hmm.
It's in the ground.
So when I have to recast it, they're gonna, if they see the hole, I want to do something.
Okay. So you're not gonna be able to see anybody up there. It's not straight back. You're going down.
Oh, okay.
That's what I'm trying to. You'll see the hole, but you're not seeing into it.
Then I'm gonna listen for them to say, like, "Hey, I found a hole."
Okay, cool. So, as you're down there and you take a moment, as you feel, you're counting in your head, 55, 56, 57, 58, and right before that 60-second mark of the spell dropping, you recast Minor Illusion. And at the top you hear, "Wait a minute! The wall, this wall was, it's up, somebody get me keys!"
I'm gonna cast Earth Tremor and try and collapse the tunnel in front of me.
Can I start running? Start running, please.
Okay.
Just hands and knees just fucking crawling as quickly as possible.
Yo, you can stand, he's gotta stoop a little bit. But you can stand. So, are you casting this as a first level?
Yeah, first level.
Okay. As you hear the door, as you hear them, so you hear people clattering. They see the minor illusion flicker for a few seconds of nothing before it pops back up. "They've got into the wall!" You hear somebody yelling, and you take a moment. You realize the jig is up. You place both little hands kind of on the ground, the sides of the wall of the tunnel in front of you, as you begin casting this in your head over and over. You speaking as you feel everything start shaking. Go ahead and roll damage.
And before we all die?
It's a six.
This would be a fun way to have everybody die, I guess.
Six.
Okay, as you're shaking, you feel a couple rocks begin to tumble and fall. You get cracked in the head. You take a point of damage.
Okay.
As more rocks fall, it doesn't collapse the tunnel, but it's weakened it.
I'm gonna start running with them.
How much is it weakened, Betty?
There's cracks in the rock around it. Rocks have fallen. You can visibly see cracks all around the ceiling.
Can I quickly try to hit it with a Thunder Breath?
Just your breath weapon?
Yeah, clip the
front. I'm gonna back behind him.
Yeah, yeah. Mm. clip, like, you know, the side of the wall, like, preferably towards, like, right up there towards him. Mm-hmm. I kind of, like, peek my head around, and then I come back out.
As Clover, as you realize it's kind of crumbling and broken in spots, you see Broke's kind of motion as you turn and run behind him. Just at the top, Broke's, as you come around the corner, you see a shadow outline of a person. The down is as this crack of lightning goes up, hits the wall, stones explode everywhere, flying everywhere, kind of peppering you in the face. Nothing big enough to hurt. As the entire tunnel starts collapsing, falling towards you as well.
Run!
I need a dexterity check from you and Clover. Gaikon, Rook, I'm going to say you're just far enough ahead.
We should be like 75. I at least should be about 75 feet in.
Okay.
I got a 5.
As I'm running, I'm going to tuck my tail underneath me so it doesn't get clipped. Preferably, if I'm able to, as I'm running, can I snatch small woman? And just, come on, old lady, we got to go. We don't got time to put a foot around now.
Imagine scold a dog.
Yeah, can I do like a deck save as well?
So, as you begin sprinting out, you kind of look over your shoulder. Her little legs are trying as a rock, as the tunnel's kind of collapsing behind you, just going, falling in. A rock catches her in the head as she stumbles and falls. As it starts going, you turn, you grab her by her little hands. Clover, you take 10 points of bludgeoning damage. That was a really good roll. As rocks begin falling, peppering you, hitting you in the head. As Roix, because you rolled the nat 20, you grab her, pick her up, and start running. The tunnel collapses another 15 or so feet. As soon as it rounds the corner slightly before it starts falling off.
Like, I want, like, full sprint of, like, Forrest Gump with football. Like, that's just how I'm running with fucking Clover right now.
Yeah, I mean, it feels like about, so the almost, from the point of impact where it started collapsing, 25 feet around the corner, completely buried.
Nice.
I'm gonna frame these dice after this campaign.
Ow.
A moment later, silence. As you're sitting in this cave, half collapsed, you hear a couple cracks, like pebbles rolling. Ahead of you, a long, dark tunnel. What are you doing?
Is Clover conscious?
Yes. I'm rubbing my head.
You see like a line of blood over the front of her face where the rock caught her and she started to get buried alive.
Yeah. I want to take like, you know, the collar of my shirt and just kind of like stretch it out, just kind of like get the blood off and like, oh, you almost got quizzed now, little lady.
Yeah, but that was a good one, right?
Yeah, I'm going for a high five.
I'm gonna.
She's dazed, missed my hand.
Yeah. I wanted to stay like just slightly ahead of Gaikon. Quietly.
I'm looking.
I mean, we heard the tunnel. If they made it, they'll catch up soon.
Damn.
Thanks, Ruka, bitch.
I'm just gonna give him kind of like a death stare, and I'm gonna start walking back towards Broba and Clover.
Wait. Broke. I'm like looking behind Gaikon. Where's Clover? Was she with you? Was Clover with you, Gaikon?
No, Clover was keeping our cover. I imagine she.
We're going back. We have to go back. We have to get them there. Let's go.
As well. Okay.
Don't we have to go.
Broba here. We shared a cell together.
So yeah, I'll start checking back with the Gaikon, check on him.
You guys push back around another bend where you see like dust just pour down the hallway, blocking and obscuring vision as you hear the end of this cavernous just rumble. And then you hear her coughing in a strange dialect that's still hard to understand.
Go, goddamn, no, quipper came over here. No, talking about like a goddamn mummy.
I'm gonna look at Clover and go, what happened?
I'm still bleeding, and I'm gonna just kind of wipe some blood. What do you think happened? We collapsed it.
It worked?
I mean, well, oh, God, I think so.
It didn't work.
I don't know how much time we have. They may be able to, you know, unbury it, maybe?
Daddy said, like, almost, like, 30 feet of, like, collapsed tunnel. That gonna be a while.
Gaikon, when you looked at the wall, how old did the repairs look?
Hundreds of years.
So what do you reckon they don't know about this tunnel? You think it's a chance?
I guess only one way to find out. We just keep going.
I mean, we collapsed the tunnel, not the cell room, right?
Right.
So they know the tunnel exists.
Probably. Well then, let's.
Did I happen?
I mean, at this point,
when I did my thing, did I happen to like get anybody or?
They weren't in the tunnel. They were up at the entrance.
Damn! Fuck! All right.
Did any of them hit their heads going through the illusion, the little 4-foot wall thing, by any chance?
it would have disappeared as soon as she cast another spell.
Gotcha.
That's why they knew the tunnel was there. They with a decent roll, were able to catch like that moment when her 1 minute ran out and she tried to put it back up. There's like a 3 to 6 second buffer. She has to cast it again. And it was just like gone. They're like, the fuck? Then wall appeared. And that's when they tried to get into the cell. And she heard
a bunch of come on, bros.
So you're saying they're smart enough to know to duck from the little blink they got. Got it.
Yeah. Though nobody would have gone after, because they would have...
They had to unlock the cell door too.
Yeah, the door was still locked, gotcha. So they had to get the keys, open it, and as soon as they got in and looked, they could see down, and that's when Clover decided to try to collapse this.
Good job, Clover. We should probably get moving.
Yeah, I'm gonna need to rest soon, but we can move us as far as you guys want to move.
So we already ran down it a ways, and apparently it's going down, so I'm not entirely sure this is some massive secret escape.
Betty, as we're moving down this cave, I want to try to find any small stones like the size of this and just kind of collect like a handful.
I mean, they're everywhere. It'd take you but a moment.
Fair enough.
Even more so with the amount of rubble that just came down.
Okay, perfect. All right, then shall we continue down? Do you want me to take point, or Gaikon, do you want to go up front?
I mean, we're only going to be able to move as fast as Clover and I move anyway, so.
All right. You want me to scout ahead?
Please.
All right. Clover.
Hmm?
I'm going to take the gag that was around my neck and just slip it up over my head and put this on your wound so it doesn't bleed anymore.
I'm going to take it and just kind of like, do like a headband type thing from my chin to the top of my head.
Yeah,
like a fucking Polish grandmother.
A babushka.
The babushka.
All right, then I guess I'll continue down the tunnel quietly, and if I sense any movement or any commotion, I'll.
Okay. You start walking down this tunnel again. It winds every 30 or 40 feet, it feels. It's dark.
Which direction does it matter? Is it constantly going
straight.
One direction, like constantly left or constantly right for the turns?
A little of both. It has kind of a meandering wind to it. And as you're going down, you can feel like, you know, a dwarf, being a mountain dwarf, having grown up to an extent in this environment. You can see this again is Not
of dwarf origin.
Yes. Something clearly burrowed or dug or made this tunnel up to those cells.
Yeah, I'm afraid of that. It's whose home did we just break into?
Crab people, crab.
I don't know. Maybe it's a huge crawfish.
Oh goddamn boy! Look at my language now.
Any food sounds great right now. I'm fucking starving.
Same.
Batty, with night vision, do I see any like fresh tracks or anything? Like the wall, ceiling, floor?
Make a survival check. Brooks, you see nothing as usual.
Yeah, I know.
I'm leading him.
That was an eight.
Okay. As you kind of look at the ground squinting with the darkness and the dust that seems to have just blown down this path, you're not seeing anything fresh, but it's hard to make out anything at all. It's a lot of hard stone and not like mud or dirt.
Got it.
Batty, like, as like, I'm assuming I'm just feeling my way through the tunnel, do I feel like tool marks or like teeth marks or...
You could make a survival check with disadvantage. Basically, everything you're doing down here is going to be at disadvantage while you're in this pitch black.
Nine.
As you kind of feel it, you're not sure if it's chiseled or what it may be, what dug it out. Yeah, you're kind of rubbing your hands on it.
I guess continue fumbling down.
Kind of that slight, not really a breeze, but you do feel air. It's stale to an extent, but you all continue walking down this tunnel. 5 minutes, 10 minutes. Still at a slight downward slope. Nothing too steep or crazy. There is the occasional drip of water as you're walking through here as it comes through a crack in the ceiling. 20 minutes, 30 minutes. As you continue walking down and down. At one point, you do kind of feel that spiral feeling, like you've walked in a circle some way, maybe underneath of it or what, but there's been a lot of turning. Your sense of direction down here is lost for most of you.
Do I smell anything?
Make a perception check. With this, it'd be disadvantage still, brother.
My nose to see.
I mean, you don't have any particular smelling ability, more so than a normal person.
11.
As you kind of sniff, it's just that same stale air.
Okay.
There's no smoke, there's nothing like that. Yeah.
Okay. Continue on, I guess.
Yeah. For what ends up being close to an hour of just walking this normal pace down into this mountain. Gaikon and Ruka, you guys are lead. Or Ruka, you're up ahead, right?
Correct.
You run into a fork.
Fuck.
One going left, one going kind of more of a, I guess not a straight fork, but like one off to the left and one spiraling to the right.
From what I can see with dark vision, does the spiral appear to be going downward? Where the left one appears to be continuing like flat ground?
No, so they're both going down, I should say. One is, the right one is a hard right though, down into a spiral like. The left one kind of meanders off to the left, but still at a downward angle.
I guess I'll wait for everybody to regroup and we have a decision to make. It appears the right side is gonna spiral a bit more. And the left still goes down, but we don't know.
I guess we just need to pick a direction and stick to it until we run out all our options, and then we backtrack and stick to the right again.
Aye. Gaikon, can you tell anything about these walls? I mean, clearly, you know, you said something was carved by it, but does this path appear used? Is there anything that would give you thoughts about that? You're kind of the stone guy.
So yeah, is this stone or is this dirt?
Well, it's
a combination of.
It's stone, without a doubt. It looks like something was carved through here, yeah. Not burrowed. Or at least not burrowed through dirt.
We've been moving for an hour. You think maybe we're good to pop a squat for a moment?
Clover immediately falls to the ground and tries to sleep.
Bro.
Yeah.
Do you play any instruments that percussion?
No, not me, no. All string. I ain't one of them, you know, drum beaters. That ain't my thing.
All right, that's fine. I'm gonna keep. I guess during the rest, if it's not strenuous, I'm gonna try to collect more of those pebbles.
Yep. Are we doing short rest or long rest?
What would you like to do?
I'm gonna suggest a long rest. I've got one rage left, and
I've got one spell slot left.
Cure wounds, and yeah, I feel like we need to. How are you feeling, Brooks?
I'm feeling fine now, boy. I can't complain.
You want to, like, maybe break a watch up with Ruka? And, well, how are you feeling, Ruka?
I'm hungry. I'm all right, but, I mean, I'm not going to say no for a quick rest. My dogs are howling.
I think maybe we should try to get a long rest in. I'm just not sure how we're going to do watch.
Well, if we stay right here at the Folk, I'll keep an eye left and right, and then I'll have to help Bro, because he can't exactly see. And we could figure that out, at least.
So, I mean, a watch can be worked into a long rest with your number. It's tight, but you can still get your full rest with each person taking a watch. It's not like that interrupts it. Unless something happens during that watch, I would say.
Well, then I suppose we could try to do it like we did in the woods. Remember the goblins?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'll take first rest, because I suppose if they know of this tunnel, or if we've invaded something space, it knows we're here, so it'll make itself known eventually.
Well, we can't rely on Rorix for watch at all. He can't see anything. So true. I guess I will,
I just want to be over there, like blinking, trying to hopefully see something, like, whoa.
Well, we can let two people sleep and then two people rest.
Right, so I'll stay up first.
I guess I'm arguing with them over me staying up first. I'm going to take the first watch. You get rest. I think I'm in a little bit better fighting shape than you at the moment.
Fair enough. I'm going to try to find, like, a fucking stone that's, like, the size of, like, a pool cue. Mm-hmm. And just hand it to Gaikon and say, well, I know it's not your axe, but maybe it's better than your fist, yeah?
Yeah, thank you.
Give him a fucking stone. And I'll find a spot, put my back against the wall, and try to take a nap.
All right. As you kind of post up and the others lie down to get some sleep.
All my senses, listening for any noises, anything at all other than water dripping.
A lot of water dripping. Go ahead and make the perception check as you guys try to rack out for some sleep down in this tunnel.
I don't even know why you have me do perceptions. Just tell me to get fucked. That's a 2.
After the battles, the jail, as you kind of look up and down this tunnel, you're not hearing anything. A lot of dripping water, the occasional, it feels not necessarily a breeze, but that stale air kind of stench wafts through. You don't fall asleep. You also, there's nothing here.
I fell asleep?
No, I said you don't fall asleep, but you don't hear anything.
Good stuff. I was going to say shenanigans. All right, so into my watch. All righty. I guess let's go ahead and wake up Ruka, since he was ready to start watch anyways.
All right. I'm on it.
All right, sir.
Limited vision. I want to try to keep an ear open for anything coming up from either forks.
Yeah. All right. So as Gaikon lies back down to fall asleep.
All right.
Make your roll.
15.
So as you take a moment listening, you're not necessarily a scratching sound, but maybe a stone fall? Something down the right fork. Echoing more so than close. It doesn't sound close, but you heard something.
From the left fork or right fork?
Right fork.
Okay. I'm not going to take an action yet, but I want to get a handful of those small pebbles I've been collecting.
Yep.
And if it gets louder, if it's something distinctive, I want to scatter the stone across the sleeping party and try to wake them all up.
Okay. As the rest of your shift goes by without any other sounds, or at least nothing getting closer, you do hear it one more time, but again, it's distant, an echo.
Okay.
What are you doing?
Well, that's the end of my watch. I guess I'll wake up Clover. At least she can see. As I go to wake her up, listen, it's probably nothing, but down the right fork there was something. Could have just been a stone, but to keep an eye on it, yeah?
Yeah, I'll try.
All right, good luck. Now, sit down.
All right, I'm gonna...
Go ahead and make your roll as your shift starts, as everyone else falls back asleep.
9.
As you sit down, you just kind of listen. Eyes closed, kind of head back and forth occasionally. Is that a crackle to the left? Stone drop? It fades away, echoing. Another hour goes by of no sound. What are you doing?
I'm gonna wake up, bro. Hey. I know you can't see well, but I need you to try. I need to sleep some more.
All right, I'm just gonna nod into the darkness.
He's not even looking at you. His head's off to one side, like facing a wall. You know, like shaking his head.
I'm gonna sigh. If you hear anything that sounds like footsteps or people mumbling, just wake us up.
All right, I'm nodding to the darkness again. Betty, does that already count for my long rest?
At the end of this, it will.
10-4, all right. I'm gonna post up and just kind of get like a Indian style, like Zen-like pose and just focus all my hearing and just kind of glare into the darkness. So like any like molecule light that pops up, I'll be able to fucking see it.
You know the rule, let's roll it, brother. With disadvantage.
Yes.
That's the name of the show.
Hey!
Hey!
12?
12.
18 would have been nice, but you know.
As you sit, just trying to not breathe, trying to not move, just to listen as your other senses of sight is gone right now. You just think. And you think you hear a crackle, a stone moving, falling. Down the left path. It fades after a slight echo. And the last hour goes by quietly.
You said left tunnel, correct?
I did.
Okay. All right. Once that's over, I guess I'm just gonna, whoever's close to me, or no, as I'm sitting, I'm just going to like feel my tail around. Mm-hmm. Hopefully I find a body, just kind of give it a little tap. I don't know who's closest, so.
Oh, it's up to.
I can't see, Batty.
Hold on. Let's see who's closest.
Here we go.
I'm doing it gently too, gently.
Daikon. Slight boot.
Bump, bump, bump. Come on. Wake up and look around for my axe and then suddenly kind of realize and remember where I'm at and pick my rock up.
Fatty, can I feel the frowny face he makes noticing he doesn't have his axe?
you feel it. You can't see it, but you feel it.
Yeah, I'm just like, okay, little buddy.
Gaikon, as you kind of open your eyes, and again, it's dark, but you can see with your dark vision. You see him again facing the wrong way. He's kind of...
I'm going to go ahead and wake up Ruka. Give him a nice little shake on his shoulder.
Yep.
Hey, wake up.
Are we good? Over. Are we good?
I'm just going to like kind of like talk over my shoulder and like, you know, I heard something down the left tunnel, but you know, it sounded like a rock. I don't know.
I heard something from the right before I woke up Clover.
I'm gonna open my eyes. I heard my name.
Yeah, we're awake now. Good morning, question mark?
Good morning. I'm gonna take a moment to prepare some different spells.
Okay. As you sorry, you can go.
Bro, you said you heard something from the left, yeah?
Yeah, that's correct.
Well, we could, I could try and scout it. If I move slowly, I'm pretty confident that we'll be all right.
Give him a nod and just kind of like get to the side of the tunnel, you know, motion, have at it.
I'm gonna go up right at the fork between both the ways that we could go.
Because if we're lucky, yeah, maybe some falling stone means an exit.
Maddie, as I'm positioning myself at the fork, can I hear anything at all?
As you sit and kind of listen, nothing right now, no.
Do I smell anything?
The same.
Okay.
Then I'll, while Clover's doing her druid thing, I'll just kind of very slowly, like, stick to one side, inside wall, and just start making my way down that tunnel. Maybe 80 feet-ish, and just see if I can find a source of any kind of sound.
Okay. So you're going alone, right? You're going to go down there on your own first?
Yeah, I'm scouting the left side.
Okay.
I think I'm good.
As you move down the left side of this tunnel, it kind of reels off to the left a little bit downward before it starts before it's curving back to the right, almost evening out from where you were. You go like 75, 80 feet or so, and tunnel keeps going. No sounds. Actually, sorry, you have dark. You'd be able to see. About 60 or so feet ahead of you, you see another split. I keep forgetting you can still see that far.
Fuck. All right. I'll start coming back to the group. And let my presence be known as I'm coming up the hallway. And just be like, oi. We have another split down this way. Bloody sucks not having any gear.
You didn't see or hear any signs of anything alive, though?
No, nothing that, made my hair stand up.
Why don't we check down to the right, scout down that way, and see what's down that direction as well, real quick?
Not a bad idea. Go ahead and do this now before we start starving.
Do I sense any animals nearby? Anything at all? Like rats or?
Nothing in the tunnel up here. You don't see anything, I should say. I don't think you have like a sense for it though.
All right, then I'll head down the right side.
Actually, I'm gonna stop Ruka.
Oop.
I'm gonna put my finger to my cheek. We need to get our stuff back, don't we?
I mean, aside from Guy calling Zach, I don't think of anything's worth going back for. There's nothing we can't replace, because if we find Jackal and Sato, we'll get paid for the people that we, the information that we found. And we can just replace gear, I hope.
Okay.
I mean, don't get me wrong, it'd be nice. I mean, we can certainly come back.
He sees a small tear, like her eyes tearing up. Okay, let's go.
What is it, Clover? You want your staff, don't you?
No, it's not the staff. It's my diamond my dad had.
Oh, bloody hell. Lads, it looks like we're finding our gear. Gaikon, I know how bad you want your axe, mate.
At this point, you, like, the tears are just kind of rolling down her cheek. I really need it back.
Well,
you also don't have that quill, just so you know.
Well, we certainly can't, we can't go back to where we came. So, shall we, just kind of poke about and see what we find?
I guess no.
Do you want to scout down to that right now?
Might as well. Wish me luck. And I'll start making my way. Stealthily.
Make a stealth check.
Ooh.
Still gonna hold my post up between the split. First fork.
25.
Oh yeah, you very quietly but nimbly begin moving down this path. About, you doing the same 75, 80 feet?
Yeah, just like a probe. I'm just kind of getting a feel.
You go down around that, and when you get about 60 feet down, ahead of you, another 60 or so feet, you can see where it splits the second time here as well. This is the tunnel that kind of banked hard to the right down as well.
Right. Do I get the gist that, well, I guess, so when we made our way from the collapsed tunnel, was it mostly a straight shot, or was there like left-right turns?
A lot of left-right turns. A lot of meandering.
Sure. Okay.
Do I still have my platinum ring I bought? Okay.
You are down to bare clothes.
Not in her case, literally.
Bare clothes. Gaikon.
Please stop.
He's an owl bear. Okay.
No, I'm talking about Ruka.
All right, then.
I think we should just commit to a path of hope and pray.
I'm nodding, just me, you know, forfeit, buddy, forfeit now.
Close enough. Then I'll come back to the group and say, another split, left and right.
All right, so what do we do? Start going left until we can't go left anymore, or start going right until we can't go right anymore?
Well, I don't have a bloody coin to flip, so.
Thinking back in the room where the stone was, were there any markings on the wall or any indication on any direction?
Not. You didn't really look.
Yeah. Okay. So, I'm going to produce flame.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Sorry. Light up the area. At the fork that we're at now, is there any indication on which direction to go?
Roix, you can see!
Oh, God, no.
As you see Clover holding a small flame in her hand, as you kind of take a moment and scan and look at the two tunnels, make an investigation check.
Betty, also, I'm going to re-examine the wall again.
10.
Okay. And you're going to try to check the wall to see...
Yeah, now that I'm able to see if it's, like, you know, tool marks, teeth marks, whatever.
Yeah, go ahead and make a survival check.
18.
So as you kind of are looking at the wall marks, it's like it was chiseled out, though by what means, I don't believe you...
Can I tell the direction of the chisel? Whether it was going in or coming out?
Coming in towards the cells.
Hmm. I'm a point towards everyone, and it's like, oh, somebody trying to do a breakout or something like that.
Or a break in. They were headed towards the cell. How big are the strokes in the stone? We're talking like a footlight whip chisel, or are we talking like little scratch marks?
Fairly big. Like arm size.
Like,
damn.
5 inches.
Think of your hand, but like that's the size of like the carve out.
Gotcha.
And I didn't see any indications on what direction to go to.
There's no markings or anything of like directly correlated to how to get out.
Ruka, did any of the pathways look like they were headed up, or at least leveled out, or is everything still going down?
The left one at first glance appeared to level out, but it winds up going down deeper. They all do.
Right.
From what I can see.
I think we should just go right the whole time.
Just stick right?
Yeah.
Alright.
Yeah, let's go right.
Better than nothing. So, Clover, if you're gonna keep that light up for bro, maybe stay in the back of the pack, yeah?
I'm gonna actually cancel it out. I don't want anyone to see us beforehand.
Alright, I wanna just give out the biggest pouty lip. Just.
It's a shame. We Darkness. Can only see that and you can't, haha.
I'm roll to swing my tail just a little bit, just enough to
hit just a little bit, listen,
but not enough to hurt her.
Yeah, you have to roll with disadvantage because you can't see her.
And I can see it.
16, bitch.
Can I roll to dodge it?
His tail cracks you a little bit. Right in the shin.
Ow.
And the last time I save your life, not little lady.
I'm gonna punch him.
Go ahead, roll to punch him with advantage.
That's it. 18.
You each take 1 point of damage because you're idiots.
I'm gonna cast a glance at Ruka and motion back to them.
Mate, she's been like this ever since I've known her. Literally nothing we can do.
All right, continue down the shrugging.
Yeah.
Can you continue that first fork and head right again?
All right, okay. Let's do it. And I'm gonna scout ahead. Hit the fork, make a right.
Yeah. My damage is actually zero when I punch, by the way.
It's one plus your strength.
I have a -1.
You have a -1 strength?
Yeah. I made it clear to swing my tail hard enough to teach her a lesson, but not hard enough to damage her, so.
My punch is like that.
Anyways, continue down the tunnel.
You both take a bit of psychic damage from the DM.
Okay.
You don't have to tell me that, bud.
Robo has an aim.
After around 120 feet of walking down this right fork, Ruka, you come to the second fork you saw. Because somebody was looking... Robo can't see. Never mind.
Well, can I cast Blame again at the fork?
Yeah, sure.
All right, I'm going to do that.
Roix, you can see.
Ah!
You have another left and another right. The right spiraling towards... not spiraling, but cutting hard right, while the left going a pretty hard left. Both downward.
To the right.
Yep. Full send right now, Bob.
Let's see. Broix, what is your passive? Never mind.
Batty, also, I guess from here to on, I just want to kind of like feel the walls since, just like detect like trap doors, hidden doors, you know, stuff along that line. It's booby traps.
Boobies. Jinx, owe me a Coke.
As. While continuing on the right, Broix kind of just holding his hands out, feeling the walls. As you go to the right, Broix, make an investigation check.
With disadvantage?
Yes, sir.
You have it. Because she has the light on still, right?
Oh, is the light still on?
I haven't canceled it out.
There you go. Straight roll, brother.
That would be a 15, bud.
15. As you kind of are holding your hands, scouting for any doors or traps or anything on it, you notice something as you're dragging your handle on it. The chisel marks on this tunnel are going forward. As in, when you made this turn, it went... It seems like this was another route dug the way you're walking now versus kind of the opposite, how it's been this whole time.
Meaning like it's going up an incline now, or?
Still not going up, but it's going down and to the right, but it was... You're now following the path that something created versus going the opposite direction. This fork seemed to have been dug out, kind of like the last one you were on was.
Gotcha. So like it could be a means of it trying to dig out then.
Yeah, I'm make it known to everyone, just like, you know, they made it out of Joe. I mean, we might as well follow them, see where they go. You know what we
full
got?
Send.
Full send, old lady.
I'm gonna cancel up a fire. Until next fork.
I will make the pouty face.
Yeah. As you guys continue walking, which at this point feels probably close to a half an hour, it's walking in dark, listening to Broix tripping every few steps.
Oh, God, no.
The wall or the floor evens out before it starts to incline. Starts going back up. After another 20 or so minutes, Ruka, you see up ahead of you another split, left and right.
Any light coming other direction?
No light.
Fuck me. Another fork.
Right side.
I want to make it known, follow the chisel marks.
I'm gonna produce flame and look for the chisel marks.
You see the chisel marks on both of these tunnels are going forward.
Which one is going incline?
The one to the right.
Let's go right.
You see the one on the left kind of even out. It's not necessarily going back down, but going right is bringing you back up.
Let's go right.
I'm gonna ask Gaikon, you have any knowledge of like underground caverns and whatnot in Atavia?
Yeah, you could say I've spent a good majority of my life in them.
Would you happen to know if like how far they stretch and if you know this area is known for it?
I would imagine they probably go on forever.
Would you say we're at the right depth for one?
For one what?
A cavern.
You're looking for a cavern? I mean, talking about like a fissure or something?
Yeah.
No idea. Sorry, I don't have like sonar abilities.
I'm a nod and just follow everyone else.
I'm gonna cancel out the flame as we keep walking.
Frowny face.
As Broix is submitted to pitch black for the who knows how many time, we'll continue up to the right.
That was a really underrated movie.
Pitch Black, good movie.
Yeah, Pitch Black.
As you continue upwards now, up and up, straightening out and up. Feels like another 20, 30 minutes of walking. Your legs starting to tighten a little bit as it's been just at a complete incline. Before you hear a sound. Hey, Broix, can you make the sound for me?
Which one?
Remember that thing I told you to keep on hand? Can you just one good twang, like a pluck? Just one string, like a string being broken, really, is the sound I need. There was no sound.
Your mic totally didn't catch it at all.
Feels bad. Did you just hear that?
No, he's muted himself.
You're muted.
Oh my god. You tried.
That's gonna bless be a your great heart. That's gonna be a great fuck clip.
Bless your heart.
Unmute!
I did.
Oh god, he just broke a string.
He did break a string.
Free for the sake of this gang.
Oh my god. Regrets? No, I was needing to change the strings anyways.
Did it sound like Brobard's? Did it sound like Brobard's actual instrument?
I mean, it sounded like a ting. You hear kind of echo. Broix.
Okay.
You feel like a pain in your heart for a moment because you've heard that sound before, and you hear it three times.
The son of a bitch.
Did you hear that?
As you kind of continue walking forward and you round a corner here, you see cracks of light through stone.
Cracks close or far?
They're a good 20 or so feet ahead of you still.
Well, I guess with whatever lights in the room, I'll scout ahead just a bit and look and see if I can find what made the sound.
Okay.
Quietly.
Stealth check for me. As you begin walking forward.
16.
Stepping quietly as you can. Where you find yourself at the back of a wall. The wall you're looking at now, it looks kind of like the last one, shoddily built, kind of seemingly patching in a hole that was blown through. Mm-hmm. You see a small crack, like, I mean, we're talking a keyhole. Which at this point in it, you can see four men sitting around a table. Stupid thing. Twings! He breaks another string, echoing down the hall. As you see him kind of take it.
Are you sure Bard Rage doesn't exist?
I mean, it's not even tuned as he's holding. And Ruka, you just look at his keyhole. He's kind of holding it up. Ting! The last string on it. Is there five? Five? I'm going to go with five.
Six.
On a loop? Okay. Twing! There goes the last string.
There's more than that.
Oh, yeah.
Each string's doubled, so.
Thank you.
Duh.
He just starts popping strings as you hear it. And you hear the three other guys around the table laughing. I mean, we could have sold it. I mean, nah, just keep going. Keep going. As he's just popping strings as they're all laughing. They seem to be drinking.
Do they appear... Well, first off, can I identify that as Brobard's?
Make a perception check.
12.
It's a loot. Not sure if okay. It's his or it.
I don't see like dragon claw marks on the frets where he's been fucking clawing away at the thing.
I mean, you don't have that good of a view. You're looking through a tiny keyhole right now, really. Got it. So.
Okay.
You see, it's a loot for sure. As you kind of scan the room, you see a few packs. You notice a few other things. You see crates of supplies, some giant casks.
Anything else on this room?
There is two doors, but that's about as hard. You can barely see the left one. It's a little bit down. You're catching the corner of it, but you see the wood. On the right, maybe 5 feet. You're very close to this door. You see one. And this one's cracked open.
Okay. And the keyhole, was that the right door or left door I was looking through?
No, it's not an actual keyhole. It's like a small hole in the stone and the actual wall of the stone. Sorry.
Okay. I'm trying to draw a little map here so I can see. Okay. So I'll double back to the group. Quietly.
Okay.
Bro?
Yeah.
They have a loot.
I know.
It's not in a good way.
It's certainly level trembling.
But listen, this room, and I'm being very quiet, obviously. Yep. This room, that hole, I can see them in there. There's four of them. They're drinking. There's supplies in there. To the left, there's another door that's closed. I can barely see it. To the right, that one's cracked open. I didn't even think to look what's in there. Shall we go check the cracked open door?
You can't get through the door. That's through the wall.
Through the wall.
Looking through a patched up wall. You know how initially bust through
a
wall?
You kept saying keyhole.
Yeah, it's like a keyhole size crack in the wall.
And then through the keyhole, I saw the door on the left, door on the right.
Exactly, the door on the right being cracked open slightly, and you see the room, the cask, all that's in this room you're looking into.
I'm gonna look at Ruka. Did you see my diamond? Or my staff?
I didn't really make out any of our equipment. What they're doing to that poor loot was all I saw. Fucking monsters, those guys.
Oh, and turn towards Ruka. You know, still in a bardic rage. Just
check for the diamond.
And my staff.
All right, 2 seconds. And I'll skulk back to the fucking hole in the wall. See what I can find.
Okay. As you creep back up. Kind of look through this small crack again.
The whole time, I just want to be staring up towards there, just, you know, 1,000-yard stare, like Vietnam flashback. Like,
you just see the shadow outline of Ruka against some of the cracks through this wall where the light's coming in. Ruka, as you peek back through, kind of looking, you think you see a pack that might have been Gaikon's? But the rest of it is pretty obscured by this table and the guys just laughing and drinking. As you see the loot thrown against the wall, there's no, just wooden sound as the strings have all been popped.
Any sign of a particular large axe?
Negative.
No, just the, okay, just
again,
the, just the
you, a lot of your view is blocked.
Understood.
I want to kind of push him out of the way gently and take a look myself and see if there's any signs of my maul as well. Or if I notice anything different or above and beyond what he saw in the room.
You're going to need to make a stealth check.
Oof.
Why do you oof? Have you seen my stats on that?
Oh, you have good stats. Okay, I didn't know if you had good stats on stuff.
Actually, before he does that, can I cast Guidance? Allows him to get a D4 plus ability check.
Also, I want to ask him just
if you see anything of Clovis, tell me.
I'm not looking for her underwear. I'm sorry. It's not happening.
Find the diamond.
God, it's terrifying. Do we add the guidance? You'd already rolled.
I rolled a 19.
Add the D4.
It's a 3.
No, he would roll. Whatever, it doesn't matter.
Okay, it's a 3.
It's also a 3.
That works.
As you kind of sneakily walk up, Ruka, you feel a touch on your shoulder. You turn around and there's a dwarf there.
Oh, good, you're here. We might need to smash the wall, maybe. Here, look, take a look, and I'll kind of guide him.
Yeah, make a perception check. Gaikon.
Who, me?
Yeah, you're looking now.
Fifteen.
As you kind of look through, you don't see your axe or anything that jumps out. You see the four hooded figures just drinking around.
Cigarette break.
You see the figures drinking around the table. And then Ruka says, was that your... And you do see... Well, I mean, Yeah, you'd see weapons on them. Again, the usual that you've seen with these guys. Short swords, daggers.
Daggers, short swords.
But just past the table, on the right side of it, as you're kind of looking through this crack, you see your pack on the ground.
Well, guys, I see my bag back behind them, but I don't, I can't tell if there's any weapons or not.
Well, if anything, it's a start. So do we maybe wait to see if they leave it unattended when we try to break down the wall?
What I'm thinking.
All right. Batty, the, like, little cavern thing that we're in right now.
Yep.
Is there any semblance of this used to be anything? Like, is there any fucking, like, salvageable anything? Wood, anything we can use to make a lever?
There's not. It seems like it was dug out and blown through the wall, and it was patched up.
Ah, perfect. Okay. I see the map. Well, what do you guys think? Do you want to wait it out, or do you want to go back and try another pass?
Yes. I'm still in favor of waiting it out. Maybe we backtrack and check what's down that last fork, the other direction a little bit. Maybe kind of have an idea what's that's that direction, so it's not completely unknown to us.
That's not a bad idea. All right, let's do that, bro.
Stay here, Clover. Or you and bro, you want to stay here, and how about I follow him? Just be quiet. Don't make any noise. Mind your tail.
I'm just going to continue staring at that crack.
I'm going to very gently put a hand on his shoulder. Just, bro, listen. We're going to get your shit back, and they're going to pay for what they did to that wonderful instrument.
I require blood.
Oh, my bad. Cigarette break.
Right. You'll have your blood. I think we all will. All right. In the meantime, do we want to hang out here, or do we want to go check the other path?
Check the other tunnel. I will watch this.
I'll stay with Bro in case he's doing anything rash.
All right, if things go tits up.
That was very clear. How, what?
I think it's because he's very angry, and we need to be careful. Say something, bro.
Bloodlust.
He's very angry.
Okay.
We need to move away from him and let him decompress.
I'm gonna stay with him.
I'm gonna back away very slowly, hands in the air. We're here to help you, bro, all right?
So, Ruka.
So we're going to explore now?
Gaikon, as you guys head back down the path you took, it takes a little bit, 15 or so minutes again, to go all the way back towards, I think it was almost 20 minutes, to go back to the previous fork. You want to go the full distance?
Yeah, we want to go back to and check the other fork, just see what's down in a little ways.
Okay.
I mean, we're wasting time to see if those guys leave that room anyways, right?
Yeah, of course.
Mm-hmm.
So you guys head back that way. It takes a few minutes, but you end up getting to that fork. Clover.
Hmm?
Brorux. As you listen to your friends go, 15, 20 minutes go by, you hear the laughing, joyous time they're having in there. What are you two doing?
I'm just gonna pat him.
Still staring. I haven't blinked.
Do I see any animals at this point? Like any rats that could be scuttering through the hole or something?
Nope. Still nothing in this tunnel.
Okay.
It's when you hear the next terrible sound. It's a little bit higher pitched. Sweet at first as something's being plucked. Bing! As a string is ripped off.
Just the lightning in my nostrils just start to glow. They don't crack off. It just glows just slightly and then goes back to nothing.
As you hear the laughing around the room, is it a harp or something? King! As another string is pulled. And you remember having a lyre, which is kind of close to a harp. And you feel it's like the sound... Lyre. You know it. As a bard who's had these instruments for years and years. Slowly another string. Ding! Laughing as you hear something thrown. Bang! There's like an echo of some strings possibly still being attached to it as it hits the ground. Clover, as you look over, you just see... What does she see, Roix?
What does Clover see?
As she looks over at you, yeah. What does she see?
Just like the slow, like pulsing glow of the lightning in my nostrils preparing. But then he settles down and just continues staring.
Okay.
I'm gonna pat her on the back and whisper, we can get you a new loot. Fine, get you a new one.
That was mine.
We can fix it. They're not gonna destroy the wood. We can go to some wizard and they can cast
magic. Bang! As another string is snapped.
And I'm gonna shudder. I'm really like can cast mending on it. It's gonna be okay. We can fix it.
Small woman, I am focused on finding the diamond and filling my claws with blood.
Trust me, I can transform into a bear anytime, but you don't see me doing that right now.
We will wait for the others to report back.
Ruka, Gaikon, you get to the fork. What would you like to
do? Fucking Vulcan Raven, the bard over there. I love it.
We're going to stay to the right and start exploring down, making sure it doesn't open up into any other areas that we need to...
Yeah,
coming up behind us.
Yeah, when we hit the fork, we made a right to get where we were. So now we're going to the left.
Yeah, I know the direction you're talking about. Yeah.
Got it. Okay.
It would be, yeah. You're both right.
Okay, got it.
So if we stuck to the right, and there was only two ways, we'll stick to the right again to go explore the new area.
Got it. Okay.
As you head down this new tunnel, which begins going up, at a different direction though, kind of up and then flat. Sorry, no, this one stayed flat. As it kind of evened out and it just continues straight off to this direction. I mean, Ru, you can see ahead of you, it just keeps going. It meanders a little to the left, a little to the right. It just keeps going and going. How long would you guys like to continue on this path?
Ruka, how far do you think we should explore this before heading back to them?
I mean, the other one was only 20 minutes. So if this was some kind of alternate way to get to that same area, we would have been there by now.
Fair enough. All right, well, let's get back to the others and see if anything's changed in that room.
All right, let's do it. And I guess we'll double back. We'll move a little faster this time.
Okay. As you guys begin moving back towards this, the first fork that you hit there. Get you back to the second fork, and as you turn that and head back towards just that first fork, as you head back up,
it's like no,
yeah, no. I know the other way, yes. As you head back up towards this room, you find Clover and kind of like holding Brox's face, like
I'm like rubbing his cheeks, like it's okay.
you still hear the sounds of laughter and whatever they're doing, drinking from up the hill. It's muffled through the wall, but you hear it.
I'm gonna break eye contact with the wall towards to Clover.
Mm-hmm.
Your bag that possessed the diamond. What did it look like?
I'm gonna describe the bag to him. Well, it was leather, and then it had some red outlines on the side, and I drew a pretty little tree on it.
All right, Betty, I want to stealthily walk up to the hole and just glance into the room to see if I see this bag. Just
let's make a stealth check.
Oh no.
It's 21, bud.
Oh.
As you walk quietly up towards this wall, get up to it and make a perception check as you look through this little crack.
That'd be a 16.
As you kind of look through the wall, you don't see the bag she's describing. You see the four laughing around. You see off in the right-hand corner, though, you see a now stringless lute. And kind of on the ground over in the corner next to it, kind of cracked in half, a lyre. With a few strings still attached, but it seems the wood, when they threw it, cracked it and broke it.
Clover, do you have any way of opening this wall, making a door?
I can cast Earth Tremor.
Batty, how far into drinking are they? Like,
as you're kind of looking at them, they're happy, they're smiling. A couple faces are a little red. They're loud.
Is it? I'm taking it since they're kind of drinking, celebrating almost. They don't know we've escaped, correct? Or they just don't care.
No real inclination either way.
Go ahead.
No, just as far as we've come, maybe word hasn't spread yet.
Gotcha. And they're wearing the robes and everything, correct?
They are wearing the black robes, that bit of like purple lining, and the big star.
All right. Just want to return back to the others. Look towards Clover.
I saw no signs of the diamond. My instruments are broke.
Well, we have some stuff there. If you guys give me a whole long rest again, I can mold earth.
I'm just gonna sit right there where I stand.
We shall wait.
Yeah, I think we should probably wait too. These guys are gonna eventually have their fill of drinking and either pass out or move on to their bunks.
That's not a terrible idea. And this time, will you allow me to do something during this rest?
That depends on who you're doing or what you're doing.
I told you once we're not doing that.
Well, all right, bro, fair enough. No's a no, I suppose. But Gaikon, I might need your strength for something. Bring that big stone you brought. And I want to go find like a piece of shale,
yeah,
or something, just like a thinner piece. And I want to, with Gaikon's help, I want to try to break this thing and make a stone dagger out of it. Just something pointy, just stick it with the pointy end.
Okay.
And if I can make two or three of them, that would be fucking fantastic.
Okay.
So where are we making this at?
Like 20, 30 feet down so the sound won't make it.
Stone in a cavern.
Maybe it's further.
Into the cavern.
Further if we need to. I mean,
noises back at the beginning area as well. I mean, I'm a little concerned that we're going to alert something that we're in the tunnels.
I just bloody hate the fact that we're totally defenseless. Well, minus, you know, Clover and you being angry, bro being able to do things. All right, I don't like being defenseless. There, I said it.
Well, what do you guys think?
What are we doing, guys?
Broryx, Clover.
If we're debating a rest, Maddie, instead of banging rocks together, I'll just try to find one that's pointy.
All right, make an investigation check.
I'm just going to sit down and start a rest so I can change my spells.
Okay.
14.
I will just stare at the opening in the wall.
Yeah, I figured you would. 14. As you kind of look around, there's not a lot of large rocks, and what there are hand-sized-ish. Nothing real pointy. I mean, something clearly dug this out in a fashion where there wasn't like a lot of debris.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Right. I'm good.
As you all,
I haven't used any of my abilities yet. I'm just gonna go ahead and offer to be the first one to take watch while we rest.
Okay. As you all begin to rest up, you sit down and relax, and a few hours go by. Gaikon, make your first roll for perception. Sorry, a couple hours, it'd be 2 hours per watch.
17.
As you're listening, you hear the sounds up the tunnel of the guys at the top of the wall. They're muffled, laughing, though getting quieter. As your rest comes to an end, or your watch comes to an end, who'd you like to wake?
I would actually like to peek through the hole real quick and just see if anything's changed inside the room.
All right, as you're kind of in there looking, you see one of them is actually passed out on the table. Just head down. The others are just kind of drinking and quietly talking at this point. One of them is wobbling a good deal.
I can't even maintain his seat wobbling.
There's two that are coherent enough that you can tell that they're sitting upright and they're talking, but one is, you know, there, and the other one's face down on the table.
I'm just gonna reach over and give Brooks' shoulder a light squeeze, you know, just like a little affirmation to him, and then wake up Ruka for the watch.
Ruka.
I blink once.
It's almost like a crusty as the dust and everything. Ruka, you're awake and you see Broryx sitting cross-legged still just staring up at the wall.
I know anger can be used as a tool, bro, but don't give yourself a nosebleed, all right?
I will repel what remains with my bare hands.
All right.
I'm just going to lightly kind of roll over, look in the other direction in the dry spot that Ruka had previously made warm and all. And dry.
Yeah, you don't want to face that. It's terrifying.
And as Brobart says, that's just, I love you. You're my best friend.
I appreciate all attempts to soothe me.
I'm just...
The only thing that can soothe my soul is blood.
Jesus.
All right, I'll start my watch. Focusing on the crack, like I don't want to stare through the crack for 2 hours, but just periodically, just check.
I'd say, I mean, around that hour mark, you see the three of them get up. The fourth being passed out on the table. The two guys helping the really drunk one, wobbly guy, seem to be helping him. Away. Come on now, get you to bed. Let's go as they walk through the open door.
Just kind of taking a second with my vision. Can I, like, the crack that we're looking through, does it travel up the wall a ways? Like, is this wall compromised like the one before?
Oh, without it, like, it's definitely compromised. There's multiple little cracks where light's shining through, but there's no hole bigger than the one you're looking through.
All right.
Still about a 4 foot area.
Yeah, sorry. Roughly, yeah.
And this is what, a two hour window I've got?
Yep.
Okay. The broken pick that I have, does it have a file, like, grating on the side of it?
I mean, at this point, it's fairly damaged from you hammering it out as well, so.
Okay. Fuck. Okay, then I'll I'll wait out the rest of my. Okay, I'll wait the rest.
Yeah, right. He's still working on his freaking prison shifts.
Well, no, I was thinking about trying to use, if there's a file texture, trying to widen that hole just a little bit so we could see more.
I mean, beat up, it would have some pretty rough edges. I imagine that would file the hole somewhat.
If I could try, yeah, quietly.
Without a doubt. Go ahead. Yeah. Let's just do dexterity.
Dex.
Or strength is probably better. Sorry.
Doesn't matter. It's a natural one.
Womp.
You see this hole, and you start, as your knuckle hits it, you're like, ah! Ting, 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 as the pick falls through the hole onto the ground. See a drunk man, his hands out, like, bracing himself. He kind of stands up, wobbles, bounces off of the wall where you're literally sitting against. The fuck did everybody go? As he kind of stumbles a little bit, walks towards the door, trips through the doorway, hits the ground. Fuck! He stands up, and you hear two more. Come on, man. Let's get fucking drunk. Let's go. Get up! As you hear somebody lift him and help him start walking off.
I will finish my watch and just kind of wait. I lost my prison check.
An hour or so, the rest of your watch goes by. You head back down away from the wall.
Clover, I suppose.
Let her sleep. I will continue watch.
Bro, you have to be exhausted.
I require no sleep.
You're exhausted.
I'm gonna creak up to the hole.
You need a Snickers or a nap. One of the two.
Bro.
I'll take last sleep.
Is this last sleep? No, this is third.
Third.
Alright, creak up to the hole, and I want to peer in. Now that, you know, everything's clear, no one's in there, correct?
Nobody's in there as of right now, as you kind of look into this.
I want to see if I'm able to identify that bag, if, like, someone moving, like, gave me a sight.
You see it about the same. The table is blocking where most of the stuff seems to be. You see that one bag that was identified as Gaikon right on the corner of the table, so it's all on the other side of it there.
Roughly how big is the bag?
It's man-sized regular travel pack.
Gotcha. Do I see a dagger anywhere?
Make a perception check.
13.
You don't see a dagger, but you see what looks like a javelin or a spear tip leaning against the wall.
Okay. Just continue my watch then.
Okay. The rest of your watch passes fairly uneventful. Nobody else comes into the room. You head back down to your anger seat.
I want to wake up a small woman.
Your time has come to watch.
I'm gonna wake up and quietly, sneakily walk over to the wall as well and watch.
Okay. Make a stealth check for me, just because you haven't had to yet.
4.
So, as you start walking up there, just having woken up, you got, you know, sleepy leg. One of your legs is asleep. You slept on a rock. You know, it's tingly. You kind of get up to the wall, and you trip. You kind of hit the wall. A couple pebbles fall off of it. Some dust. You look through the crack of the wall. No one's there. What are you doing?
I guess prepare my spells for the day while the others rest.
Okay. An hour goes by. At this point, who knows what time it is? Been underground, completely devoid of light. And you remember it was getting kind of late originally, so it's like hours and hours, maybe a new day. You're under your watch. Kind of comes and goes. Nobody new enters the room. What are you doing?
I'm going to quietly walk back.
Okay.
Quietly as I can. And wake up everyone.
First, I want to wake up and immediately look around hunting for my axe, realizing I have nothing but my new friend, the Rock.
I call him Kane.
And I am able of using him.
Oh my god, you did not just...
The tunnel? Can I collapse the tunnel right now?
Please collapse the tunnel on everyone.
Alright, Thunderwave D20, good game, bye guys.
Alright, what are we doing, guys?
I think now's as good a time as any. Is there nobody in the room?
The last time I checked, there's no one.
Alright, last I saw that drunkard had woken up when I dropped my pick and...
I'm gonna quietly walk back over.
I want to make the suggestion,
open the wall, grab the stuff, return to the tunnels, and collapse the wall again.
Ruka, you might want to help me gather the things. I don't have long arms.
I can help. I know you can barely see over the damn table, too.
Okay.
Question, Clover, are you able to hold the wall open while we run in, and then as soon as we get back, you can collapse it again? Like,
or I can.
One and done type thing.
It's a cantrip. I can use it as many times as I want, and I can basically excavate it, move it along the ground, deposit it, cause shapes, colors,
Gotcha.
I can basically get rid of it.
I vote for getting in there, nabbing all the supplies, and returning back to the tunnels and continue. Just stay in the shadows, because I don't necessarily want to roam the hallways.
Might be a bit less scary with some equipment, but...
What, Ruka, which door did they come from originally?
I saw them leave through the one on the left when that...
Right door. The one that was already open. Okay. That's still right cracked door. Open. Or sorry, it's okay. Wide open now that the drunk dude went through it.
Okay, I would like to mold earth and move the 5-foot cube to that right door so it blocks that door.
So are you... You wouldn't be able to mold the stonework. It's unworked, right?
I can move it along the ground.
Hold on.
And deposit it 5 feet away. It doesn't cause any damage.
Okay, so yeah, you can move. Or some dirt stone that you can see within range that fits within 5 feet cube. You manipulate it in one of the following target area. Loose earth. See, it's not loose earth. This is like stone. It's
okay.
Well, the wall isn't stone, right?
What about the earth?
It's also not earth. Loose earth.
I can't even excavate it? Like, just get rid of it?
I mean, you could do that without a spell. But the spell itself is to move and shape loose gravel, earth, stone across it. Not to shape or... It's not stone shape. There's a specific spell that can move and shape stone.
Oh, okay.
Mold Earth is more so for digging a hole, per se.
If I Kool-Aid man my way through this wall for her, can she turn around and take that rubble and use it?
I'm going to say no, honestly. That's blocks, again. This spell is meant... mold. If you were talking stone shape or a higher-leveled spell, sure. But with Mold Earth specific, it's kind of outside the realm of what it can do.
Betty, that door they left open, what kind of locking mechanisms on it?
It looks just like a typical small square lock set in the wood.
Got you. I want to cast Mage Hand to close and lock the door.
Okay, so you walk back up the stone, and it's within 30 feet, yeah. You send out your hand as this little kind of shimmering light blue hand. Grabs it. The door shuts.
Brox, move the chair underneath the doorknob.
As you wish, small woman.
Beeline straight to my bag and start looking around for my weapons.
We haven't gone through the... Yeah. The
wall's not open yet.
You'll have to beeline through the wall first.
Since it's a character, I can cast it multiple times, correct?
I mean, you just hold it out there, yeah.
Gotcha. And then, since the door is locked, I also want to...
It's not locked. It's shut.
Got you.
Get that
chair. Is the door one of those kinds where a chair can block it effectively?
No. Not from this side. It was open out, not into the room.
Got you. And will the lock on this side help at all?
Gotta find out.
Fucking lock the door, I guess.
Your hand goes over, there's no latch. You need a key of some kind to lock the door.
How long does your mage hand last?
You get me in that room, I think I can lock it.
1 minute.
Keep that mage hand up and just keep the door closed while we get in.
Block the door with mage hand and fucking...
Like, keep that door closed.
Yeah, and just...
Read mage hand.
Okay. Mage hand, No, I think it's actually for grabbing shit. Never mind. I can't hold shit open with it.
Well, you could try, but there's a... How much weight can it... How much force could it put behind something?
Ten pounds. So that's...
Nothing.
Pretty much nothing.
Okay, well, I guess our best bet is to just try and open this up.
Okay, yeah, I'm gonna look towards Gaikon and just nod.
Y'all gonna have to make me angry again. I need to rage.
You remember the thing that the other wall said about your bear friend? This one's talking about your heritage. Saying dwarves are stupid rock munchers. Can you hear it? I can hear it.
I don't hear it.
I'm good.
I'm good.
I'm raging, and I'm plowing through this wall.
Gaikon, make a athletics check with advantage for me. As momentarily, you just think back to all this stupid shit Ruka says, because he says some dumb stuff, and you rage. Your eyes and vision whites out for a moment. Your muscles tense and build up as you charge at this wall.
Okay, so 19 plus athletics, which is 15, so that's 24, and then am I adding proficiency as well?
Athletics already adds that to it.
Gotcha.
So 24, so, as you jump at the last second, shoulder and head crashing through the wall, making a second dwarf-sized hole. As the rubble and wall collapses in, dust pours back down in the tunnel and fills the room momentarily. As you clamber up, put your hand on the table, look over it, you see an axe laying on the ground.
Maddie, nice. I want to dash to that door and try to use my remaining pick to lock it.
You step through the dust and you see the door as you push over and you run to go try to lock the door. We're going to end tonight's session.
Bitch.
You bastard.
You bastard.
Thank you everyone for hanging out tonight for D&D. Real quick, my name is Batty. I am your DM. Thank you for hanging out and watching, and please go give all of my friends a follow, starting with Golden Icon, playing Gaikon, the Mountain Dwarf Barbarian, Jazzy Wazzy 94, playing Clover, our Forest Gnome Druid, Gaddy, playing Ruka DeLance, our Half-Elf Thief Rogue, and of course, Go Broba Fett, who I have severely hurt tonight, and I am apologizing for immensely. And thank you for breaking your guitar strings.
potentially considering playing Tarkov with you now for reasons completely other than what just happened.
And of course, GoBroBuffet playing Broix are insanely furious. Bronze Dragonborn Bard, who just had his instruments destroyed in front of him. Thank you again, everyone, for watching. We will be live every Saturday, 9 p.m. Eastern, playing Dungeons and Dragons. This is Disadvantage. This was Session 7. This will be on YouTube shortly. If you're on YouTube, hi, come follow our channels. Otherwise, I'm going to kill the recording. See you guys next time.
They all must die.